This is how a wee bay desisted. You ask me double eyes. We help a wee bay.
Why waffle?
Hacker, hacker!
Las Vegas, Nevada, May 31st through June 2nd. Join a bunch of juicy hogs, a bunch of Discord dorks, a bunch of pay pigs, a bunch of sad incels, a bunch of podcast nerds, a bunch of complete hacks, a bunch of stupid puppets, a bunch of fat losers. Nobody likes onions. Who are these podcasts? Tookie, BeDabbler, Ray DeVito, Pat Dixon, Earl Skakel, and more. For a weekend of stand-up and live podcasts in Sin City. Get your tickets now at Hackamania.com. What you gonna do when Hackamania runs wild on you?
Guess what, Stevie Lou? I will still blow you.
So when the Pope opened his trip to Korea with a speech in English.
Dear God, make Rocco Burrow, one of his kids, a homosexual, please. And better yet, a transsexual, transgender, please, God.
He sounded good. For the record, he is working on his English.
No. I just wanted to bury whatever hatch we have. Doodle, thanks for 2 bucks. Ignore the piazza potato. Don't play into his head. I'm done with the potato. Do you like the potato, Kate?
No, I hate the potato, and I hate Tookie even more.
Yeah, so do I. I do.
They're horrible, horrible individuals.
So, are you in Manhattan, or are you?
Get your dumb ass up, cause it's time for Tookie Soup. The taste is gonna move ya with OJ and Ralph. The taste will make you lose it when you pop it in your mouth. Tookie Soup is gonna move ya. Stay the show, but it'll soothe ya. Tookie Soup, the taste, is gonna move ya.
Yay!
Well, at least the intro was great, sir.
Shut up. I'll explain. Whenever I yell over the music, no matter what, on YouTube, it becomes highly overmodulated. It doesn't matter how low I make my fader. So I just let that music play now. And then I'll say, yay! Welcome to Tookie Soup, episode 29? Holy shit.
Damn. Modulation is important, sir.
It is proper modulation, but that's the thing on the audio podcast. Everything sounds fine, but for some reason with StreamYard, when you play music and talk over it or something, it just fucks everything up, at least for Tookie, but whatever. That's why I did that. And I need to think of something now to play before Tookie actually shows up on screen, or maybe Tookie will pretend like he's talking to someone like, oh, we're talking to Ralph and it was, oh, boys and girls, there you are. Like once the music ends, so I have to figure out a new opening because it literally makes my ears bleed when I hear the opening on YouTube.
Testing, testing. 1, 2. We are now testing this out for proper modulation.
Proper modulation. What'd you say?
You're a genius, sir.
Thank you, Ralph. Thank you, Ralph. Thank you, OJ.
I love the new intro, sir.
So it's do great. I do too. That was fantastic.
Your timing is just a little bit off, though.
Sir?
Are
we losing part of Tookie, sir?
What?
Tookie's chin? Yes.
Oh, what the hell?
Ah! Oh, my God!
Good eye, Ralph.
No, I was looking at that, and I was like, oh, my God. I think so, but
he's got a bald spot.
Oh, my God.
Are you growing? Started from, sir?
Oh, no. This is exactly what I feared. My days are numbered. I'm a hack.
I think Cardiff may have some extra hair he could send you.
I'll send it over, sir. It's horrible.
Looks like a soul patch.
Oh, no.
Tookie's dying.
Oh, no. Oh, I don't even want to do a show now. This isn't a show. Oh, we're not doing a show. Oh, I just want to fix Tookie now. Oh, I have OCD. Oh, Tookie does not have alopecia.
Tookapecia.
I knew just throwing this thing on the floor after every show was going to fucking come back to hit me in the ass.
You obviously have a backup, right, sir?
No! Oh, man. I feel like I can glue it. Fuck. This is Tookie Soup. This is one of the last... This is the countdown to the last episode of Tookie Soup. Tookie's days are now numbered. Tookie's going to start falling apart. Oh, thank God. That's okay. It's okay, everybody. False alarm. Everything's going to be fine.
How's that, sir?
Because we have a backup plan, Potato. Okay. Yesterday at like 4 or what? No, actually, I think I tweeted about it at 4 in the morning. I didn't actually buy this at 4 in the morning. But this is what we will go to if Tookie dies.
You really bought that?
Yes. I don't know why. I don't even know when I'd wear it because at live events, I mean, I'm just going to be El Horrible. I just thought it would be fun to have someone walking around in a Tookie costume in Las Vegas. But then someone said it'd probably be very hot to be wearing that in Las Vegas.
The Guatemalans do it, sir.
Yeah, maybe hire a Guatemalan.
I also don't know anything about this website, AliExpress, but from what I've said or from what I've researched, even before I bought it, I researched this. And a lot of people said, it's kind of hit or miss. like you'll either get your thing or you won't. And oh, they were like, don't spend more. It was like a gambling website. They said, don't spend more than you're willing to lose. It was like, what?
I endorse AliExpress, sir.
Do you?
Yes, sir.
Oh, they work. Okay, because I've never used it. Again, this thing.
Half of Cardiff's masks have come from AliExpress, sir.
Oh, okay. Wonderful. Is it really a long shipping time?
It can be, sir. Especially if this is big. But sometimes some things are like 2 weeks and some things are 2 months.
Yeah, I ordered it last night, so I know it won't. It's not even expected to come until after Largo. So don't expect to see this in Largo. It definitely will not be there. It's coming from China. I will immediately remove the tongue and color the nose pink. If anyone has a really good way to paint that fabric, I'm assuming it's fabric. I was saying earlier, because I did a Tookie Loves Mud Sharks, Loving Misery, because Chad actually sniped MLC today a little bit. This seems like one of those things where if you ordered the red Tookie, you'd probably get this Tookie. But the fact that I ordered a green Tookie, I feel like I'm going to get fucked over. You're going to send me a red one.
that is likely to happen, though, sir.
That also seemed like a possibility. My mom is not
exactly get some sort of dye
thrilled, right? I guess, that I bought this. No, but she's very supportive. But yeah, so our goal tonight is $198. That's the goal. Yeah, so this will be coming once Tookie is no longer operable. But I think, like, I really think if I just glue, I have to just glue that hair like that.
Yeah, that should be all right, sir. But you know the best part?
Shut up.
The best part, sir, is when you come up with like something big and exciting like that for a live show is to spurl it months before it ever shows up.
Oh, sure. I was excited.
I know you were excited, little
Tookie,
boy.
Tookie, you know what else you can maybe do? You can maybe cut off a little piece, some of the hair at the bottom of Tookie.
And yes.
Glue that hair on there.
I was just thinking that. That's so funny. While Cardiff, or I mean Ralph, was speaking and I wasn't listening to him, I realized there's so much extra Tookie to be used. Yeah, yeah. Look at all that extra Tookie. Yeah.
You said your mom's box, sir.
It's like a jellyfish. Oh, yes, that's right. Thank you for that, Ralph. We will be signing off every show now with John's mom's box. That's our new sign-off, even for BeDabblin Live. So always BeDabblin has been retired. The last words you will hear on this show, I guess it should be after that's the end of our show, Donk. We'll save your mom's box.
It's the end of an era, sir.
Yes, end of an era. Oh, I'm not gonna, I can't stop staring at my bald spot. I was looking at it and I was like, no, that must just be the light. But then I was like, I never actually looked at Tookie until you said it. Like, I was just looking at it on the screen. And I'm like, why does Tookie look like he has a bald spot? But then you said it, and I actually looked over at that point at the actual Tookie, and I was like, ah! It's staring right at me. I see my thumb.
This show is magic, sir.
You can see my thumb!
Doxing, sir.
Fuck. I need someone to make a new Tookie. Also, announcing today, right now, Tookie t-shirt contest. It's not going to be a lot of money. I think, I need a t-shirt design for Vegas. So somehow incorporate Tookie and Vegas. The least amount of colors you use, the better, it seems. But I think I'm going to have like 100 t-shirts made, like limited edition Tookie Vegas t-shirts. But I need a design. So send them in to TookieSoup@gmail.com. And we'll make a contest out of it. But hurry up, because we only have, you know, a couple months until Vegas, and I have to order the shirts. But yeah, so for the next 2 weeks, we're doing a contest. And it is to make a Tookie Vegas t-shirt design. And I'll figure out, you know, how much the winner gets.
So where would they send it? To TookieSoup.com?
TookieSoup@gmail.com.
TookieSoup@gmail.com.
Yeah, we have the little layover. You
can't send an email to a website, OJ. Layover. That would be stupid.
Oh, I thought he would have known that. But he has no idea, does he?
I didn't.
There you go, Tookie Soup.
Shout out to Old School Ralph.
Well, you said all your Tookie and BeDabbler needs are at TookieSoup.com.
Yes. But yes, if they want to email me, they would need an actual email address, not just the website. But yes, the email address is on TookieSoup.com too. So eventually people with brains would have realized, oh, here is his email. I know this is how I will get in touch. So yes, send your t-shirt designs to TookieSoup@gmail.com and make sure they're high res and transparent and all that crap. Don't send me a Microsoft Paint thing.
John's transparent, sir.
Yes, John is a transparent. A fantastic transparent. Oh my God, I think I have to retire Tookie until Largo. I think Tookie has to go into the shop.
Yet, Carl has been promoting Tookie will be in Largo, not El Horrible, sir.
What about a giant green Elmo with a red tongue?
Wouldn't be the same.
Oh God, all right.
You gotta start hanging Tookie up when you're done with him.
Yeah, I think I have to start respecting.
Stop fucking Tookie, sir. A little bit.
Stop fucking him, Ray. So yeah, we're going to do that though. Melissa Young, thank you for gifting one BeDabbler Network membership. That's fantastic. Thank you. John Naj, $2. Bob and Perry are streaming now. Go get them, Tookie. Oh, fantastic. Say No More, California or Canada, $2. Oh, I almost sounded like Chad. For hair plugs, yes. They're not plugs. They're individually placed green follicles.
Hair system.
Yes. It's a whole system. They're not plugs. Deadbeat Lux, thank you for being a member for 3 months. I'm happy to be here for my cancer-ridden puppet. Yes! Tookie has cancer. He's losing his hair.
What have your farts smelled like lately, sir?
Oh! I don't know. I don't feel like I farted in a long time.
Good for you, sir.
That's true. Good, I mean, I pooped. But no, nothing out of the ordinary. Nothing that reminded me of my nana. Gordon Shumway, thank you for the $5. TWO and OJWO, Ralph smells like a potato. Hope the gaydar is working. Yes.
Check out this TWO thumbnail.
That's fantastic.
Thank you.
Wonderful. Gordon. Gaydar. If it was broken, we would need a gaydar aid. Hacka hacka. Flat Cat Jessica, $2. Welcome to the old age club, Tookie. I'm not that old.
You're literally falling apart, Tookie.
Oh my God, this is my worst. I totally thought it was going to start happening like here, or, you know, where all this, you know, constantly going up and down. But it's where my thumb is pushing out.
I wish someone was more gentle with fake Tukey this weekend, sir.
Yes. God damn. Why did you break it?
Pretty close, sir.
Did you throw it out?
I launched it a couple times.
Son of a bitch.
Didn't know Hunter, we would need it.
Hunter Duke, thank you for the $4.99 for the goal. See you in Largo. PWO, TWO, FKB. I will see you in Largo.
Traitor, Hunter Duke.
I will see everyone in Largo. Tukey will be there, even if he's in pieces. Underdog lady, $100. Wow. Thank you so much. I love you more than a friend. I give up all my worldly wealth to follow our savior, Tukey. Tukey World Order forever. Underdog. I will not call you Underdog Lady because you always said that was not what your name is. You are portraying Underdog, so we are supposed to just call you Underdog. So thank you, Underdog, for your generous gift of $100, which will go towards the Tukey Alopecia Fund. Thank you. I hope to see you in a town parade one day. I never got to see that live. I would have loved to have seen an interpretive dance of Underdog, the cartoon, whatever that means. Yes, Ralph.
Sir, when the time does inevitably come, will you sell tiny pieces of Tukey to like Upper Deck that they can issue like
yes
cards with and people yes can buy a piece of Tukey?
Oh,
maybe God, they could sell it on the shopping network, sir.
Big things were in line for Tukey. Video games, ice cream flavors. It's all gone now. It's all going to be thrown out. No one wants a broken Tukey. That's it, OJ. It's over. It was a fun ride while it lasted, boys.
At least you can perform in nursing homes, sir.
Yes, with Ray. I would probably give Tukey to Ray and go, here, Ray. Think of an act. Joe Dicker, 25. Joe Dicker, thank you so much for the $25. Soul Patch Talkative Tukey.
It's in it with music, though. You got to sing it.
Soul Patch. Oh.
Soul Patch Talkative Tukey.
Yes. Yeah, you're right. You sing it, Ralph.
Soul Patch Talkative Tukey.
Soul Patch Talkative Tukey. Soul Patch talking to Tukey. Oh, Tukey's going bald. I'm so angry. The show's over. We're not doing a show. I mean, we haven't done a show for 18 minutes, but don't expect any much more of a show because I'm just going to bitch about how I'm falling apart.
I wish you didn't bring it up, OJ.
I'm so angry. I'm so. I knew this day was coming, but I thought we still had at least like 5 years. Why is this puppet so cheaply made? Detroit Dabbler, $5 towards the goal. We are doing it. Yes. We're doing it all right. All right, we're doing it. We're doing it all right.
So that puppet has a lot of miles on it.
It does have a lot of miles.
It literally does have a lot of
miles. It really does. It's been stuffed in a bag for miles, stuffed in people's crotches for miles. Kinky Loco, $1.99. Any juicy Dappler gossip? Funny you should say. Or ask.
Razzle dazzle is Dappler gossip with Tukey.
A little gossip, a little chat, a little idle talk of this and that.
Shh. It's Dappler gossip time. Starting off with email. Or no, well, yeah, let's start. Well, no, let's not start with email. Let's start with, who could it be? Because the email thing goes to our first segment. So it's better if we do this way. Oh, shit. What were the two? Oh, yeah. Okay. All right. I got it. What drunken audience seat filler for the Tonight Show may have been doxxed by a super chat? I wonder, who could this drunken substitute teacher be? So, if we read this correctly, Brock Lee sent this super chat to whoever that drunken substitute audience filling tonight's show, mug raising, child not raising, child support not paying.
But still not getting it, sir.
You know, think about it a little bit. It is a blind item. We do not reveal our sources here at Dabbler Gossip. But if you read this, it says, sorry, I missed your... Oh, so sorry I missed your car last night. I was at the basketball game. I was planning on calling you tonight after the show. Figured you were working during the day, so did not want to bother you, Johnson.
Sir?
Yes?
How is it that you could do a impression of every hack comedian in the Dabbleverse, but you... To do a Chinese accent, you went from an Italian to a Chinese to a South African.
Shut up! Shut up! I know
I stink. He's right though, Tookie.
I know I stink because I was at first. I was like, okay, I'm gonna go all in and just do the Chinese accent, and I was like, I don't know, maybe I should. Tookie's a hack. I'm falling apart, literally. Boys and girls.
Possibly this is the turn.
That's crazy. Oh, this is the turn. This is definitely Tookie's turn. Oh, I'm just worried. Oh, God. Oh, it's like he has a tumor.
Now you're just going to keep picking at it.
I know.
Stop picking at it, sir.
That's why I think I have to retire Tookie until Largo. I don't think we can do another Tookie suit before then. Oh, God. It hurts my heart. Anyway, I wonder who could it be who might have a job during the day? Did you see that, OJ?
I did see that.
Brock Lee.
Lots of people work, sir.
But John? Does John work? Is that what he's inferring here?
Well, he does claim to talk to Brock Lee on the phone all the time. So Brock Lee would know.
What did John do when he saw this super chat?
He kind of just moved on. He got this. He was very excited to see Brock Lee in the chat and get this $100 super chat, but he did not keep it up very long, and he went right over to a $2 super chat.
He ignored this to go to a $2 one.
Yeah,
it's fantastic. All right, and now for a second. Who could it be? What citrusy faced beloved member of the Dabbler and Hackverse community was recently seen eating the ass of a female show host who has not hit the goal in days? God. I am
Kinky
not
Kinky Loco, sir. Please let it be Kinky Loco, sir.
I am not at liberty to tell you who this tangerine-headed gentleman is, but I will say he's obnoxious. Play the clip! Oh, sorry. Disgusting. Is that just a... Oh, there's no video?
No, there is video. You added in.
Oh, where is it?
You're all at it.
Oh, I have to play it. I'm an idiot.
Yes. Roshi, do you have any plugs or anything you want to plug?
Oh, disgusting.
Bass Pills channel tomorrow at 5 p.m. Whatever time that is in America.
Hell yeah. Shout out to our boy, Bass Bill, for sure.
That's it.
All right. As I told you here on Dabbler Gossip, we do not reveal our sources, and we do not reveal who could it be's are. That is up to you to decide. What the fuck is going on with my lighting now? This is horrible. This is not a show. This is not a show. In other news, Dabbler Gossip, someone, it's Chad, was tricked into thinking that they were talking to someone else. Chad got an email from one shitware. The Shuli Network reached out to Chad. Could this be part of the reason why Chad will no longer do KB? Or is it just because KB will not pay him anymore? I wonder. But we have the email.
Hey, buddy. Couldn't help but watch what happened yesterday on MLC. I get what you're trying to do, but I think KB crossed even your line. Bob, Mike, and I discussed it, and we want to give you the freedom so you can do your own thing without being under the heel of that monster. Let us know what you think. You already know our numbers are better than Brennan's, and we have the infrastructure so you can make more money than you were expecting. We'd love to have you, Shuli.
Chad Zumach replies,
yo, I appreciate that, Shuli. I'm weighing my options and going to take some time to think it over. I have shows with Nick this week and next, so I'm just going to focus on stand-up. I was only back on Kevin's show because I couldn't fight with him and Melton at the same time. I know it's a countdown to him turning on you, so I was more prepared this time around. He also didn't pay me for doing his entire show, hoping I would make a big deal about it, but I'm not even going to mention it.
Now, I cannot tell you who sent this fake email, except that it was not Tookie, it was not OJ, and it was not Ralph. But other than that, here at Dabbler Gossip, we do not reveal our sources. And remember, we're always watching. Yeah, so...
Is it Chad Zumach, sir?
Yes, it was Chad Zumach. That wasn't a who could it be. That was just Dabbler Gossip.
These games are too intelligent for me, sir.
But yeah, that was... I think that was Monday. So a lot has happened since then. But that was Monday. Chad thought that the Shuli Network was reaching out to him. And Chad said he's weighing his options. He's trying to figure out, you know, what to do. But the one thing he will not do is mention the fact that KB didn't pay him. Because he doesn't want KB to use that against him. So... You know what Chad did today?
What did he do, sir?
He mentions that the only reason he went on MLC in the first place was because of the money. And now he's not going on anymore because KB won't pay him. No! It's ridiculous.
But if Kevin says, I'm doing a show for free. No, I'm not. I'm not doing your show for free. If you're saying I'm only doing it for the money, you're goddamn right I am. You're goddamn right. I'm only doing your show for the money. The same reason Ray DeVito does it. The same reason Pat Dixon does it. The same reason Stevie Lou does it. They're doing it for the fucking money. Because it's not a fun show to do.
We do it for the money.
When you just call me a piece of shit for 2 hours. And you got your hype man jumping in too. So I got three against one. I got the Super Chatters. I got Pat Dixon. And I got Kevin coming at me.
Who's the hype man?
Stevie Lou coming after me. Ray's coming
Pat
after
Dixon,
me.
I guess.
Pat Dixon. He thinks he's saying Pat Dixon was the hype man because Pat Dixon was he's a ball washer. Mm. He literally washes Kevin Brennan's balls with his mouth.
Oh.
According to Chad.
Speaking of Pat Dixon, sir.
Yes. Pat Dixon had his channel terminated. Oh, yeah. Oh. What former member of Compound Media and thrower of the punch that knocked Gino back to Compound Media? No, I don't know what I'm talking about. Pat Dixon lost his YouTube channel today. And that sucks. It's bullshit.
Yeah.
Apparently, I guess Pat had another channel that was terminated by YouTube. So this is seen as trying to evade your termination?
Yes, sir.
Why would they care? Like, why? It's such a dumb.
Well, as I understand it, sir.
Yes.
It's kind of like if you steal from Walmart or if you punch somebody in an MGM property, you're banned from all MGM properties.
Oh.
So think of YouTube as MGM properties.
That is a good way. Now I totally understand. Yes. But yeah, so that was a big bummer. So follow Pat on Twitter at Pat Dixon to you know, see what Pat's next move in is. And Pat can also be seen on censored.tv, which is Gavin McInnes's platform. So he's on there, so you can see him there, and I'm sure he'll pop up somewhere else. Maybe Rumble, Patreon, I don't know. All this crap. But yeah, so Chad makes it very clear that the only reason he does would do Kevin Brennan's show again is to get paid. It's like he said last time. Kept saying I will do Kevin's show for less than $1,000 or something like that. Then he did it for like $100. Yes.
Hold on, I think I figured something out. There was a chat. Hold on.
A Chad. Chad's in the Chad. Tookie wears a pink mask to hide his bald spot.
You think it was the ski mask pulling that off that did that?
Oh, thank God. That's right. I could always just make Tookie mask permanent.
No, but I'm saying, do you think it was the mask that did it, though?
Sir? I don't know. No, I think it's literally because that's where my thumb is always pressing when I do stuff.
Enough
I feel
about
like...
puppets, sir.
What?
Nothing.
But I can't. Like, I'm trying to do it without having a finger down there. It doesn't work. I have a finger down there. Oh, I've been fingered. But yeah, all right. So then Chad sent some more stuff. I don't remember what he says here because I didn't mark it.
Listen, Pat, I don't like you. I don't. I think you're a piece of shit. You're a scumbag. I don't hate you.
Oh, interesting. Okay, so.
What?
Thanks, Chad. So Chad thinks Pat's a piece of shit, a scumbag.
But he doesn't hate him.
No. No. Haven't you ever looked at a condom full of jizz and went, I don't hate you. You could have been my baby. But now I'm going to leave you in this girl's wastebasket.
No, you should bring him home with you, sir.
Yes, that's what I was going to say. Oh, wait, no, I'm not. I'm going to put it in my pocket like Eric Nagel, the sex bagel, because of all that valuable cumsies. The girl would wait for Eric to fall asleep, go into the trash can, get this disgusting condom out, untie it. Well, I mean, if Eric was a gentleman, he would tie the condom. So then the woman would have to untie it, possibly with her teeth, because, you know, the knot is too tight. Then empty that condom of his old, watery, now cold, room temperature cumsies. Mm-hmm. And somehow get that in her vagina so that she may give birth to the Nagel royal seed.
And now, sir, you've obviously heard the expression. Tell me if you've heard this expression before.
Yes.
There's nothing worse than a hot load of Eric Nagel's seed.
Yes.
But that's incorrect, sir, because you're saying a cold load.
Yes.
Would be worse.
Yes, it loses all that texture and becomes all runny. Like it just turns, like you can almost, I assume that's all the sperm dying, you know? But yes, it's all in the condom. And then he would take it home with him. But, good on you, Eric. It was fantastic.
Now, just for the record, that means the vagina juice from the outside of the condom is all over his pocket.
Yes.
Walking home. Okay, got it.
Yes.
Vagina juice.
Oh, yeah. So, anyway, haven't you ever looked at a condom like that and been like, I don't hate you, but I have to take you with me because I hate the girl I just had sex with and I don't want to be with her for the rest of my life. That's basically what Eric was saying.
But I don't like you. I don't find you funny. You're terrible on podcasts. You can say whatever you want about me, but I bring it on podcast.
He brings the ruckus.
I bring it on the podcast. I'm a good guest.
You bring what? You bring craft services? You bring bagels for everyone? Or what? Because, I mean, no, I will give credit where credit's due. I've always said Chad is a great guest on MLC, but as a host of his own show, holy crap, he's stinkeroo.
I tried. I actually watched him today for the first time. Yeah, I know. Willingly. Yeah. But I did find it interesting. He started the show talking about how stream sniping is gay and he's not going to do it ever again.
I started it. And then all these other losers, they watered it down like 20-minute-year-old cum.
And then about 10 minutes later, he was sniping Kevin.
Yes, you're right. Shit, I should have pulled that clip. You're absolutely right, OJ. Fantastic observation. Yes, Chad was bragging about, I started all the sniping and it was cool back in the day, you know, like back in the 2023s. But then everyone started to do it and it became lame. Oh, MLC's on. Let's snipe them.
I'm a great guest.
He is a great guest. You are a great guest, Chad. I will say that. But as your own host, you stink. You stink of the toilet. You stink
and as a human, sir.
Yes, and as a human.
And as a taxpayer.
And as a taxpayer, yes. I know it's been done to death, which is why I did not pull any clips. But on Monday, Chad explained that everyone who has ever worked for a 1099 is stupid. And we all have shitty accountants because Chad, who I assume only gets paid in 1099s, got a giant tax refund last year. Now, if you know anything about 1099s, it's basically because, you know, you own your own bit. You're working for a company that is paying you, but they're not paying your taxes. So they pay you what they were going to pay you, and then you are responsible for the taxes. Most of the people in this universe, all these comedians, they all get 1099s. You never get a refund.
You're so smart, sir.
Unless, yes, thank you. I'm explaining it to the boys and girls, you dick.
You're a genius, sir.
Not everyone works with 1099.
I'm complimenting you, sir. I don't know why you're getting angry, sir.
Fuck. Oh, I just can't stop staring at the spot. So anyway, to get a refund is unheard of unless your deductions, unless Chad drove around the country 50 times and put all that mileage up there. And, you know, he is a traveling comedian. You know, mileage does count. But as we all know, Chad basically just plays in Florida and stuff like that. But he should not be getting a tax refund. But yes, that was hilarious. And then the fact that he did not know that YouTube took 30% of his money. And then he was like, well, can't they just use that to pay my taxes? I don't get it. It's like, no, you do not. But it was kind of adorable. It was adorable in a way. But here's another clip of Chad.
Kevin, hello. Ray DeVito can't stop going on podcast.
Oh, yeah. This is Chad the Tattletale. So this is Chad saying, oh, I'm in trouble. Well, how come Ray gets to do it? Shouldn't Ray be in trouble too?
It's pathetic, sir.
Ray DeVito goes on every fucking show, dude.
These are children. We are dealing with children. Everyone fights like children. I'm going to call your work. You're a loser. He's a loser. I'm not the only loser. Ray's a loser, right? Too, right, Dad? Please tell me Ray's a loser.
Every show, he's on WATP. He goes to their events.
You're doxing him.
He's not booked. He's going to Pottstown. He's going to Hackamania.
Hacka Hacka.
He's going on Joe Matarese's show. He's going on anything.
Bragger.
Send Ray the link. He's going on BYB. He's going on Ski Mask. He goes on everything.
Aren't those all shows?
And you Chad just let it go.
On? Or has been on?
I'm sure Chad's been on all those shows, but they don't, you know, no one asked Chad to go on their shows. So Chad, I sense anger. And jealousy, night and day you torture me. But yes, I sense some jealousy. Could Chad be jealous of one Ray DeVito?
He could be. But you know what's funny, Tookie? I don't know if you saw this, but Chad was just defending Ray just a few days ago.
I know. Well, that's the thing. It's like things happen. That was a few days ago, OJ. It might as well have been 10 years ago at this point.
That is true.
It's ridiculous how fast. That's what I'm saying. All the tax things just happened on Monday. It's Wednesday. And it already feels like the tax stuff is old news. It's ridiculous. Stevie Lou was attacked by a nunchucking giant Newport. What is happening?
I thought it was Phil Elmore at first, but then, yeah, he said it was a Newport.
It's insane.
New York's a dangerous place, sir.
It is. Well, the fact that someone attacked with nunchucks did not even make the news. Like, crime there is like, yeah, whatever. Like, not everything's, you know, it's got to be pretty extraordinary to make the news here in New York. I mean, guy with nunchucks, boring.
So I may have video of Stevie's attacker, alleged attacker.
That's him. That was the guy.
We have to say allegedly, sir.
But allegedly, that's him. Here's another clip of Chad. And then I was going to play Chad's hype train, but then I realized I probably should have sped it up because it's like almost 4 minutes, but Chad makes like $2. I was going to say we could count the super chats, but there's really only one. But this is another clip of Chad.
Mondays with Mazer is not a moneymaker.
Okay, this is the most self-aware Chad's ever been in Tookie's humble opinion. Except with the stuff about Mazer. Mazer stinks.
It's not. I know. I'm well aware of it. It's a show I like doing with my friend Tony. It's us catching up. We'll text throughout the week, but we get to talk on Monday, and you guys get to watch us talk. It's a phone conversation. It is what it is.
Isn't that what you want in your shows? A phone conversation between an open micer and Chad? Oh, I should have said Antoni.
I don't want to be on a phone conversation, sir, let alone watch someone else's, sir.
Right? Who wants? Yeah, exact. Good point, Ralph. Who even wants to be on their own phone conversation anymore? You text everybody. No one gets on the phone anymore. Chad is very old school in that way, and so is John.
I would watch that, sir. I would watch Chad and Tony Mazer's text conversations.
Do you think, like, when Tony and Chad aren't doing a show together and they're on the phone together, do you think they both are lying on their stomachs, on their beds, kicking their feet up in the air?
No, you hang up.
going through the yearbook. Oh, remember that time? But, so here's Chad talking about how he knows, I know, we don't make a lot of money with Sit Down Mazer, but it's a passion project. Sit Down Mazer isn't a moneymaker. That's what Kumia's Cucks is for. Because he doesn't even do Sit Down Zumok anymore. He does Mondays with Mazer, and then he does Kumia's Cucks. So Kumia's Cucks is the moneymaker. And that's why I was going to show the hype train, because then he does a hype train for a whole 4 minutes. And the whole idea of the hype train is to get people to donate, but I think he got like $2.
Dabbleverse show. It's not like, you know, we're not covering steel toe. We're just doing our thing. We're just talking. If you like it, cool. There's some people that do like it. I know it's.
When he looks in the mirror, is that Cleveland hat like the right way?
No, because it's upside down.
Yeah, right. It's not like I thought it was one of those ambulance things, you know. So like when you look at it in a mirror, it's the right.
I think it would be in a mirror.
Yeah, I think it would be too.
Yeah.
I don't know. I'm stupid.
In a mirror, it's upside down. Mirror isn't going to make it
flip. Oh, that's right. Yeah, it's upside
down. Yeah, you're right. Yeah, it's upside down.
No, but it would be upside down still, but I think it would be.
It would be the right way, but it would be upside down. Right.
Yeah.
Upside down.
I know. Yeah. I know, Melton fans. I know. But there are some people that do like, and there are people that like Tony.
Liar!
And from time to time, people will send us Venmos and other
things. Why are you lying?
Super chats.
So Tony is a very nice guy.
I don't just do the show for the super chats. It's
oh wait, Tony's the one with the big arms?
Yes, and he's very nice.
Yes, yes, Tony is very nice. Tony, very nice. Very nice, Tony. You are very nice. And sorry what Tookie said earlier. But yes, you were very, you seem like a very nice guy. You seem like a great guy. Get a glass of milk together. Then maybe, you know, do some dumbbells and other stuff like that. But yes, I think Chad's a liar.
I'm not lying. I'm not lying, all right? I'm not lying. I'm not lying.
Danny Brophy, member for 3 months. Please use my membership money towards the fund. Oh, speaking of memberships, if you go into the description of this show, you can click a link and immediately be brought to where you turn on your gifted memberships. And that will be in all the shows moving forward.
Right now, sir.
Yes, go right now, Ralph. Go in the link in the description and it'll bring you right to your gifted memberships. Turn it on. That's all you have to do. No more explaining. No doing shit. OJ, who told us about that?
A beloved chatter messaged me this morning and told me how to do it.
Thank you to that beloved chatta for telling sure. OJ. Yes.
I have other big news.
Oh, what?
I also clicked the like button while I was there.
Click the like, you cowards. Stop being such a coward and click the like. Thank you, Ralph. You're fantastic. You should be in marketing.
Should, sir.
Dang Lizard, thank you for the €5. Not able to help with the puppet, but I probably can help with setting up the super tip plus OBS stuff. Just need to find the time. It's 2 a.m. here now. Yeah, you know what? It's not even OBS that's a problem with my thing. It's the fact that I use a Rodecaster and we can't understand how things are coming in and out and working, actually. Like, I don't know. I know Melton thinks I'm very stupid because I have the Rodecaster and everything, but it works for what I need. And yeah, that's about it. But yes.
Sorry, the Rodecaster stupid, sir?
I think it doesn't work for the super tip. It probably does, but I can't figure out all the configurations. I have to figure out what's going on. But man, Van Meter, thank you for the $50. It's fantastic. Another donation going to the Tookie Alopecia Fund. God damn it. Look at that. What are we going to do?
You're still beautiful to me, sir.
Shut up. Just shut up. Why'd you say anything?
It was OJ, sir.
Oh. I know how to fix it, Tookie. We'll talk after the show.
I'm not sucking your dick if that's the answer. I knew you didn't know. Underdog, thank you for the $2. $2 for Tookie cancer. That's fantastic. Hey, that's less than a box of Girl Scout cookies. That's a big deal. $2 for Tookie cancer. Another thing. Maybe I'm just crazy. Four. What?
Four Tookie cancer.
Oh, yeah. Four Tookie cancer. Another thing I'm seeing lately. Maybe I'm just going crazy, and maybe I'm just going a little more crazy now that I know I'm having bald spots. But is this eye, like, shaking and googly?
Yeah, when you touched it. Oh, yeah, now I did notice it. It fuck. Did.
Fuck!
Which eye?
That one?
Yeah, it is. Yeah.
All right, like, at the end there?
Yeah.
Tookie's falling apart!
I'll just tell you now, you gotta take it to a seamstress. You could probably find somebody at like a laundromat or something, like a family laundromat, and they could repair it. I promise. Yeah. I've had jackets and all kinds of things fixed.
Like oh god, Tookie's gonna die. Detroit $4.99. Tookie could glue white fur as an homage to Mike Morse, the super comedian, derp. Oh no, you know why that would work? It would look like that Talk Soup guy that used to have the patch of white hair. John, what was it? John Henson or Jim Henson?
No,
John Henson. Jim Henson's a puppet guy. But yeah, no, that's not a bad idea. But no, I don't want that. I want to be green. Addicted to Ubiquity, member for 5 months. See you in Vegas. See you in Vegas. Fantastic. Hackamania.com. Get your tickets. Also, we are less than 2 weeks away. We're almost a week away from WATP Live. Actually, a week from tomorrow, Cardiff and I will be there. Yeah, we only have a week, Cardiff.
Fuck.
We're just thinking of ideas now.
I mean, Ralph. Oh, shit.
Ralph. Yeah, Ralph. But yeah, get your tickets. WATP Live. I forgot to have my banner. Yeah, WATPlive.com. Well, I mean, of course. Yeah, whatever. .com. And get your tickets. Seriously, we're hanging out all weekend. And I guess we're going to a baseball game.
Stop talking about.
Why don't you want people to know about the baseball game?
I want it to sell out, sir.
What's going to sell out?
Baseball, sir.
Spring training sells out?
Every day, sir.
How many people do you think are going?
Move on, sir.
Maniac. Dupa Dupa Do, $2. Where did you come up with Boom Shakalaka? Well, let me tell you, it's kind of a funny story. Tookie never said Boom Shakalaka, and then Tookie had a song contest, and Hackride made a bunch of songs that highlighted the phrase Boom Shakalaka. And now it's Tookie's favorite catchphrase, Boom Shakalaka.
You're a genius.
From downtown! What?
You're a genius, sir.
Thank you. Oh, yeah, on our Patreon right now, you can listen to all the entries for the song contest, including Hackride's 4 different Tookie songs, which all, again, highlighted Tookie's famous catchphrase, Boom Shakalaka. So go check that out. Patreon.com/BeDabblerNetwork. Waiver, member for 8 months. Sir, Cardiff was more voice than puppet. He around?
No.
No, Cardiff is not around. I haven't had a new Cardiff since Detroit. And then I found that Cardiff in December. It was all fucked. It was in my bag. I forgot to throw it out. So from September to December, Cardiff was in my production bag. But he was in a cool, dark place. And he was just very wrinkly and soft. But he had none of those growths on him. So that just shows, store your potatoes in a cool, dry place.
Well, no, but only the lady potatoes grow those things, sir.
Oh, dark place. What? Not lady?
Potatoes. Yes,
sir. Is that true?
Yes, sir.
Wait a minute. Is this another, like, Canada doesn't recognize leap year type thing?
Possibly, sir.
Max Brangle, member for 7 months. Have fun in the 10 to 12 inches of snow coming. Yes.
20 inches, not 12.
Oh, did I say 12? Yeah. Yes, we are hunkering down here in the great state of Colorado. We're supposed to get a lot of snow. So there might be some surprise Tookie shows if certain things happen. Maybe we'll pop up. Maybe we'll do some sniping. Maybe we'll snipe that quad father. Since his legs don't work, he should be pretty easy to snipe. You know what I mean? Can't really go anywhere. Sitting duck. Fish in a barrel. That's what we say. Daniel Poon or Poony, thank you for the $5. Just when I thought I couldn't love you more after, has your son ever queefed in your face? Then you know underdog doesn't like underdog lady. TWO, of course. She hates it. She does not want to be underdog lady. She is not the underdog lady. She is underdog. When she does that interpreted dancing, she is becoming underdog. Mm-hmm. Fucking lunatics. It's crazy. It's fantastic. Maybe Ray should do that. He could get booked on all these town parades. He should do Mighty Mouse. Can you imagine Ray dressing up as Mighty Mouse and doing interpretive dance?
Here I come to save the day. They say that Mighty Mouse is on his way.
It'd be fantastic.
I might have to get him to do that this summer.
I bet it pays better. Has to
it
be
does, sir.
It has to parade, pay better.
Parade season is huge.
Yes. And it's coming up, Ray. We're coming up on parade season. Driven by Demons, thank you for being a member for 6 months. 6 months. Tookie, OJ, Cardiff, Dr. Steve, T. Dransky rule. No, Driven by Demons, you rule. Thank you so much. Gunga Din, bring water. $5. Stevie Lou got hurt yesterday and KB paid him. Tookie, if you tell KB you are hurt, maybe you could get paid.
There's another Stern reference, I think, there. Gunga Din.
Yeah, Gunga Din. Bring water. Bring water. Yeah, that's Grillo in his Gunga Din outfit. But yeah, no. Tookie does not want to be paid by Kevin Brennan.
Never.
No. I do not want to be owned by anyone except for Carl. Carl's the only one who owns Tookie and tells Tookie what he can do.
But you wouldn't mind, sir.
Well, yeah. I mean, if he wants. Oh, yeah, I'm hurt. Oh, KB. A Newport with a flamethrower came by and he ripped the hair out of my chinny chin chin. Oh, God. Fuck. It's now just becoming a reality. Like, I have to fix this. And I'm angry. This shouldn't be happening. Does Tookie have a warranty? Oh, Uma, Ken Otto had a spot like that before he got diagnosed. Shut up. Shut up.
Why would you bring that up, OJ?
Oh, Uma. Dick. Did he really? No, he had a pain in his neck, though. And now every time my neck hurts, I'm just like, oh, no, I've got the Ken Otto disease. Just like Lou Gehrig's disease. Only it makes you very boring. It makes you read liberal news to sit the same six people every week. And then you don't trust anyone else.
Remember how mean we were to him when we were doing a telethon for him, sir?
No! What? Were we?
I think so. Yes, sir.
Shut up. You were mean. Tookie was loving.
I don't remember being mean.
Yeah, I don't remember being mean when we donated like $500 to his GoFundMe. Which John was right. It didn't help him live. Remember John said that? He's like, John's like, I didn't donate because I didn't know it was, you know, I didn't know he had a GoFundMe. And what's the difference? It wouldn't have helped anyway. He said that. He fucking said that. Apar, thank you for being a member for 4 months. Karma is coming after Tookie. Stuttering John strikes again. Yes. This is going to be everywhere tomorrow. John's going to do his victory lap because Tookie is losing his hair. Tiger Lily, member for 1 month. Don't let chat try Tookie on in Vegas.
That would be the most interesting thing he's talked about in a while, sir.
What?
If he talked about you tomorrow, sir.
Yes, that is true. If he did talk about Tookie, at least it would be something different. Hashtag save Tookie. Yes, please do not ask to use Tookie at any of the live events because now I'm even more... inclined not to. I can't believe Tookie's falling apart already. Okay, but whatever.
Even white people, sir?
Yes, even white people. Normally, it's just Asians and brown people who we won't let into Tookie. But yes, this time we have to also include whites. I'm sorry, whites. I'm sorry. I know everyone's disappointed. But we'll see you on the next one after Vegas. Then we'll see how things go. And then at that point, still no to all the Browns and Asians.
Well, don't count Tookie out yet. I promise you can get that fixed. It wouldn't be that big of a deal.
I'm just going to burn him. It's over. It's over.
Probably best, sir.
Mm-hmm. We'll put him in with the Pottstown posters whenever that happens. Stupid. Dr. Oz, 199. Chad subbed for Stuttering John's show, and it was brilliant. Yes, that was a while ago when he did his own Hypocrisy Police. And then John struck him. Yes, it was all broke. Yeah, we used to use parts of that episode in the Tookie Soup Open when Chad was drooling on himself because he thought that, you know, that was comedy.
I miss it already, sir.
Yes.
The good old days.
Dang Lizard, €5. The This Is For Kumia oil can incident was the last time Chad Zumach was interesting. As our savior, St. John, says, you can't zummock the Zumach. Zummock. Yeah. Well, that's the thing. His name is Zumach.
Stomach the Zumach, sir.
Stomach the Zumach. He's so stupid.
He is, sir.
You can't duped the stupid? I don't know.
Brilliant, sir.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Ralph. Oh, we have so much to get to. Gordon Shunway, thank you for the $2. Chad looks like Mimi from Drew Carey to drop. TWO drop. Oh, I don't have the TWO drop. I'm sorry. But yes, he does look like...
Oh,
he does. He looks like my asexual aunt that we called Butchie. because she looked like a biker. She looked like a biker guy.
Sexy.
Not that Chad looks like a biker guy, but he does look like an asexual aunt who looks like a biker guy.
You know, called your aunt Butchie.
Yeah, she was Aunt Butchie. Because she looked like a Butchie dude.
So, did you call that to her face or just like when she wasn't around?
All the time. Yes, Aunt Butchie. She knew. She had eyes. She knew what she looked like.
Yeah, she wasn't Aunt Blindy.
Yeah, she wasn't Aunt Blindy. She was Aunt Butchie. So yeah, we used to call her Aunt Butchie because she looked like a butch biker guy. But Chad does not look like a butch biker guy. He looks like a woman who looks like a butch biker guy.
How long before there's an Aunt Butchie in the chat, sir, with a great...
And three, two, one. Oh, no, DeWired Christian. Nope, that's not Aunt Butchie. But yes, he does look like her. I miss you, Aunt Butchie. Everyone in Tootie's family's dead. The wheel of cancer, just spin it. See what you get. Tookie's just waiting to find out what the wheel of cancer has in store for him. Literally every type.
I'm hoping for the best, sir.
Thank you. What is the best cancer? Is there a good cancer like Hodgkin's? The good Hodgkin's?
I'm not sure, sir.
Is it prostate? Like, that's pretty...
Caught early, sir. It's cured. Oh,
but you probably have to go to the doctor for that, right?
Yes, you need to get a finger in your ass, sir.
Shit. All right, never mind.
It's fun, sir. You'd love it.
Gunga Din, I have Tookie in the death pool. It's not a horrible choice.
When you're interviewing doctors, sir, I recommend looking at their hands.
Oh, that's a great tip. That's fantastic. Is there such a thing as dick cancer?
Yeah. The dude, Donnie Brasco, the dude had dick cancer. They called him something half cock, whatever his name was.
Yeah.
Oh. Wasn't that a movie?
Cancer of the Prick. Yeah, but that was based on a true story.
Yeah, but was he talking about just prostate cancer or testicular cancer or something?
They
would have said it.
Feel your stupid nuts for lumps.
But I don't even like doing that.
It's fun, sir. I'll do that one, sir.
Shut up. I can't touch things on me. Like feel for lumps. I know it's weird, but I just
sir.
What?
For the benefit of the show, can you check them now, sir?
Oh yes, sir. Yep, they're there.
No, I mean really check them now, and I want to see Tookie's reaction to what he feels.
One, two, a three, all three. No, I will not be feeling my testicles. This is not a show, but just because it's not a show doesn't mean it's a filthy smut filled 2 hours.
Doesn't mean it's not, sir.
I mean, we've all seen you in a shower in a hot tub rubbing on your man boobs.
Yes, that is true.
And the milk, sir.
A lot of gifs came out of that, or gifs, gifs. GIF. But yeah, there was a lot that I never saw before, and then I started seeing a couple of weeks ago on Reddit. A lot of me, like, yeah, thank you, Ralph. A lot of me, or El Horrible,
keep swinging straight,
swinging his tit with the pasties. There's something, I don't know. There was a lot of shit. It was really funny. Someone made GIFs of them and was posting them on Reddit. It was really funny.
And people can say whatever they want about this organization, sir, but hell, are they creative?
Yes. We have...
Do they try shit?
Yes. We literally have, I think, the most talented and creative trolls in all of Trollville or whatever, the internet. I don't know. I'm sure there's other ones, but my God, that's why I'm saying t-shirt contest, design a Tookie t-shirt for Vegas, somehow incorporate Tookie in Vegas. The least amount of colors you use, the better, I think. But you could also use a bunch of colors, and then I'll just have to find one of those companies where they don't charge you per color. But I don't know. So get your creative juices flowing out your ass and send your, high-res PNGs or Photoshop files to TookieSoup at gmail TOOKIE-6854@gmail.com. All right. Let's take a break from everyone's favorite part of the show, the super chats, to actually do a show. I know, you know, it disappoints everyone when we get away from the super chats, but there's plenty. We'll be back. And let's do guy stuff.
I want to feel you deep inside of me. Guy stuff. I want to feel you deep inside of me. Guy stuff. I want to feel you deep inside of me. Guy stuff. Deep inside. Wanna feel you deep inside of me. Guy stuff. I wanna feel you deep inside of me. Guy stuff. Wanna feel you deep inside of me. Guy stuff. Deep inside.
Guy stuff. What's up, losers? It's your day, Turbo Melendez, with another episode of Guy Stuff, Spring Break Edition. I'm here on location at Spring Break, finding out about all the latest guy stuff. Hey, paragliding. Now that's guy stuff. Beach volleyball. They don't make it more guy stuff than that. When I think of spring, I think immediately of guy stuff. And you know what else? Baseball. Because baseball is total guy stuff. Remember Lilith Fair? Guy stuff. Hanging out by the pool. That's guy stuff. Hey, wet t-shirt contests. That's some guy stuff, huh? Remember, if you're going to go partake in spring break activities, be sure to look out for your buddies and your friends. Being responsible is totally guy stuff.
I want to feel you deep inside of me. Guy stuff. I want to feel you deep inside of me. Guy stuff. I want to feel you deep inside of me.
Guy stuff.
Deep inside.
Guy stuff.
Fantastic. Thank you, Turbo Melendez. No one listened to Tookie when he says other people don't have jokes. Just forget about that stuff that Tookie says. Because if you just keep saying a catchphrase over and over, that's comedy. So, ignore the... Yes. See, ignore the fact that your amateur minds thought there were no jokes in that last segment. As we all us semi-professional comedians understand, there were tons of jokes in there because Turbo kept saying his catchphrase, guy stuff, over and over. Yes, exactly. See, Carl knows. A catchphrase substitutes for jokes. So that's why we invented guy stuff, because we don't actually have to write any jokes. We just say guy stuff, and people laugh. So.
It's really deep by being shallow, sir. Is that what you're saying?
Yes.
Yes.
That is a wonderful way to put it, Ralph. I love it. I love all this. This is wonderful. This is brilliant. We're all doing it. Speaking of doing it, I wish I had some sexy music right now. But speaking of doing it, Ray DeVito was recently on Joe Matarese's show. Yay! How was that?
Sexy music, sir.
Can you play it again? I didn't really get a sense for what your idea of sexy music is. That's pretty sexy. Boy, where the drums coming from? Oh, this is a real song? Oh, I thought you were playing that on your guitar.
Oh, no, sir. I'm not that good, sir.
Oh, okay. Oh, I thought that was... Yeah, I didn't realize that was a real song. But yeah, Joe Matarese had Rayon. Isn't that some kind of deadly gas that comes from the ground?
Yes. Well, I think it's a type of, I think it's t-shirts are made from it, sir.
Yes. Either way, it's horrible. Not to say that Ray DeVito is, but yeah, Joe Matarese, but Joe is. Yeah, Joe's pretty horrible. Joe stinks. But he's making a name for himself in this universe, so that is good. Except now I have another shitty show I have to watch Monday through Thursday. Oof. Has he always been doing these shows Monday through Thursday? Does anyone know?
I have no idea. I haven't even seen this show.
Okay, Joe, because yeah, Ray.
He's new getting... to live, sir. He always did pre-recorded things.
Okay. All right. Then that might answer a question I have later from one of the clips. But yeah, because I've known Joe to be podcasting for quite some time. He did the infamous Fixing Joe podcast at the Cellar with Jim Norton and Artie. And who's the other person? Colin?
Colin Quinn.
Yeah, Colin Quinn. But I guess Joe is now new to the live format of podcasting. But he's very intrigued because he keeps seeing these little, little dollar signs and numbers on certain chats. And Joe likes those. Those are wonderful. Those are called super chats. Yay!
You're a cuckoo clock, sir?
I do. I never had one, but I do know. Yeah, why? What?
Did it just go off?
Oh, do I have a cuckoo clock?
Yes, sir.
No. What are you talking about? Why do you keep hearing things? Stop listening to the background of my house.
I heard a cuckoo clock, sir.
I can assure you there is no cuckoo clock. But if you want to go back and find the audio, I would gladly play it. I still want to play Chad's hype. Maybe we'll play Chad's hype train at the end of the show because it really was funny to watch him dance for 4 minutes for nothing. And then he's like, oh, man, that song's really long. Like, did you guys notice how long that show is? And it's like, yeah, it's really long when you're sitting in your fucking bare apartment dancing to it, hoping people send you money and all you get is $2. That could be a pretty long 4 minutes. And then he's just, but he doesn't dance. He just bops around in his seat and moves his arms like a Richard Simmons like patient. You know how Richard Simmons, you know, patients all sat in bed and they would all move their arms.
It's like the exercises on my 600-pound life, sir.
Yes. Yeah. They just do little arm flares. That's what Chad does.
Kind of like voguing.
Yeah, like all that kind of shit. But yeah, maybe we'll play the hype train at the end or you know, something like that. All right, here is
Will that be before or after your mom's boxer?
Oh yeah.
Before. Maybe
before. I don't know.
We're okay.
I think it has to be before.
You gotta figure out these new rules, sir.
Here's Ray on Joe Matarese's show talking about a movie he just saw, but he doesn't know the name of the movie.
We got some love out there. And I do want to dabble in the Oscars here, even though Ray said he didn't watch any of the Oscars last night.
I didn't. I watched some of the movies. I couldn't get through Maestro. Maestro was one that was nominated. I just could not get through.
You know it's so, Maestro, right?
Whatever it is. All right. I got this with the Southern John Rose. It's Menendez, not Melendez. Or Melendez the...
So Ray watched an entire movie about a maestro and thought the name of it was Maestro.
Maestro, sir.
But did they ever call him Maestro or you the team?
They had to have.
Right? But the whole time Ray's like, I wonder when they're going to say the name of the movie in the movie. They keep talking about this Maestro guy, but they never talk about Maestro. Defender of the universe. Like, what is he talking about? Could you imagine that? But imagine watching a maestro and knowing that he has to know what a maestro is, right?
I don't know.
But meanwhile, he's going, hey, this Maestro movie is okay, but I don't get the title. I mean, talk about a title that has nothing to do with the movie.
Sir.
Oh, how are you going to defend this?
I mean, he does have a podcast called the Rock Bottom Podcast. What does that mean? Yeah.
It's his life. The whole life. Yes. Does it ever get better?
Maybe. I hope so. Oh. I wish him well. Oh. Hopefully, I hope Ray wins the lottery.
Yes, me too. Ray. Yes, Ray. You should be buying at least one scratch-off ticket every trip between Ohio and New York and buy one in every state. And I, you know, you have to win something, right? Or at least lose your money quicker. I don't know. But no, we love Ray, and that's why we goof. But Ray, I mean, the Menendez thing, again, even Tookie, that didn't catch Tookie at first. But Maestro and Maestro, like, you watched the movie.
Isn't that salami, sir?
Salami.
Maestro salami.
Oh, I don't know. I never heard of it. Possibly. Yes. And?
That's all Serbs. Oh, okay. I want a sandwich now.
I was just trying out my improv skills. Yes. And?
Yes, sir.
But yeah, but that was fantastic. Never change, Ray. That's what I want. That's the main thing I want to take from all this, is that we should never want Ray to change. He's wonderful. All right, and now here's Ray singing a Frankie Valli song. Now with this, I actually did speed up because it was very long.
That I've never seen before of me and this girl that I remembered when I saw the picture. I go, yeah, I did think I did date her, and I think she cut her hair short right after that, because that's her with longer hair. Maybe when I first met her, maybe dated her for a month or two. I think that in like 1988.
Dawn, that's a great Frankie Valli song too. Dawn, go away, I'm no good for you. No, that's a. Do you like Frankie Valli? You're a.
I love Beatle Frankie
from Jersey.
Love Frankie. Jersey Boys is one of the best Broadway plays I've ever seen, and I'm not a Broadway guy.
Holy shit! We need to do a new bit with Joe Matarese called Italian Stuff. Like, as long as it's Italian, Joe Matarese loves it, no matter what it is. Does he not like anything that's Italian? Like, is there anything Italian he doesn't like?
He definitely likes talking about it, sir.
Yeah, like everything Italian. Like, Jersey Boys is the greatest piece of art in our generation and our parents' generation.
His tour is called the Italian, the 97.3% Italian tour.
I know, but this is so weird. And yeah, I want to get to that because there's another clip where he actually brings up to Ray. Oh, I don't know if I got that one, but he did ask Ray what kind of ethnicity does he like the audience to be. And I was like, for Ray, as long as they're fucking breathing and sitting in a chair. Actually, they don't even have to be breathing. As long as there is some kind of physical body or something that resembles a body in the chair, Ray is good.
Ray's not ready to subdivide his audience into
Ray's like
different racial categories.
Yeah, right. Imagine Ray coming backstage at the beginning of the show and be like, oh man, a lot of people out there, but man, are there a lot of Indians? Oh, I fucking hate performing for Indians. Motherfucker, I knew there were gonna be a lot of fucking Indians here, but holy shit, I didn't know it was gonna be this many Indians.
But you want the right amount of Indians, right? Sir?
Yes. You always want the right amount of Indians. I guess. I don't know. I'm trying to think of something. Everything I think of is horribly racist.
Your personality was built for this forum, just so you know. For this fucking media style right now, Ray DeVito, you're top notch. These guys
I have fun with it, man. Like, a lot of people like shitting on, so I did a ghost roast. Stuttering John did not show up last week. Nor did I think he was going to show up, but I
love that.
Anyway.
Let's do that.
Oh no, this is where. Oh yeah, with this clip, this is where you realize that Joe Matarese and Ray might be on the same level, because, man, when Ray was talking about doing another roast with no one else, and Joe Matarese is like, "Hey, that's actually a pretty good idea. We should do that." Like, you're really smart, Ray. You seem to know a lot. You seem to really be tuned in with this whole Dabbleverse thing. And you know all about the super chats. I mean, you know all the colors. You know the colors they are and all that. Hey, that's a red one. That's a good one. You want those, Joe? The red ones are good. Oh, wait, that's a super sticker red one. Those were bad. So it's kind of difficult. You know, it's like the English language. Like, sometimes you can spell a word different ways. Sometimes you see a red super chat and you're like, yes, $100. But then other times you see a red super chat and you're like, oh no, 99 cents. Don't worry, Joe, stick with me and I'll teach you all about the super chats. But yeah, it's crazy in this episode because, yeah, Joe was kind of like,
yeah, you know, you kind of know a lot about this stuff, Ray. It's kind of impressive. I mean, you must be a real big shot in the Dabbleverse and the Hackverse.
I mean, he doesn't say that, but, and then Ray's like, yeah.
Yeah, I'm kind of a big deal. Yeah, I get a lot. People respect me here. You know what, Joe?
I will say I might not be the biggest entity in the Dabbleverse, but I am definitely one of the most respected.
And again, let's roast somebody that without them knowing they're roasting. They're being roasted.
No, he was invited. It was his idea. He said I was a shit.
No, but wouldn't it be like fun to roast somebody who doesn't know they're being roasted? And
okay, so this is funny because now Joe's just thinking of this as like, oh, that's a pretty good idea. I can just talk shit about people without them knowing, like instead of actually having them there. I kind of like that, Ray. And then Ray's like, no, you don't get it. I invited them, but they didn't show up. And Joe's like, yeah, I know, Ray, but I'm just thinking, like, maybe we do it and we don't tell the people. And Ray's like, no, you don't understand. I told the people, but they didn't show up. This is great.
Like, oh, he got the invite. He was invited.
No, I'm saying
he's the one that challenged me. It all started. He challenged me at MLC. He challenged me to roast. I'm like, dude, it's on. I'm roasting you. Whether you want it or not, I'm roasting you. You already threw out the
This conference. Is every conversation with Ray.
We're roasting.
Yes.
And then he didn't show up. So I roasted him by myself. And a lot of the people are like, oh, that was the worst thing ever. Ray took the biggest L. Dude, I made $400 and almost 5,000 people watched it. 385 people liked it. Yeah, it was a win for me. I usually don't get 5,000 people watching one of my streams. So, yeah, it's up. It's up. It was a win for me. So I'll take it. If that's,
that's a
loss,
a win. That's a win.
I want more losses. Give me more losses like that. Please. I'll take more losses like that. I need more losses in my life.
No matter what they're going to say, it's a loss. So don't worry about
it. Exactly. Yeah. I'll take more losses.
I'm saying let's roast somebody, but not invite them on purpose.
Oh, no, I invited him.
I see what they're saying now that you're saying you're stupid.
Did you hear Joe at the end?
Here, listen. I missed.
I know, because Ray still doesn't understand. Like, he gets it, Ray. We get it. You invited them and they didn't show up.
All I'm saying is let's do a roast about someone, but we don't invite them. No, but that's what I did. I did invite them, and they didn't show up. No, Ray, I get it. I understand what you're saying, but I'm saying, no, but I did invite them.
It's crazy. Oh, but listen to Joe.
God, I need more losses in my life.
No matter what they're going to say, it's a loss. So don't worry about
it. Exactly. Yeah. I'll take more losses.
I'm saying let's roast somebody, but not invite them on purpose.
Oh, no, I invited him. I invited
you. I see what they're saying now that you're saying you're stupid.
So, Joe, well, that was a big win. Big W for Joe Matarese there. Fantastic. Oh, my God. So funny. Just so funny.
It's
so
amazing. Funny. Ray is truly amazing.
He is. So we were talking about earlier, Joe Matarese, he's been podcasting for a while, but then he had a clip that said that he's all new to this. But I guess Ralph explained it by saying that Joe is new to the live form of podcasting. But
that's correct, sir.
Right? Yeah. But I'm going to play this clip anyway.
You're a talk show host for a living. You're basically doing the Oscars five nights a week. So those are the best people to use on those shows if you want them to look like they know what they're doing. Those guys know how to read off of teleprompters, right? You see me doing podcasts. Not very comfortable yet. Yeah, it could take a long time. I don't know. I'm not used to this. I'm not used to talking to you guys and looking down and pulling up super chats all at the same time. I don't know how to do it that well, but I try to do it. And that's why, again, why Jimmy Kimmel was really good.
So Carl says, all these idiots are trying to do their own version of MLC. You are absolutely correct, Carl. And even right there, Joe basically admits it. He's just like, I don't
really know what I'm doing yet. I'm learning, but I'm gonna, because in the next clip he talks about how I'm gonna do this Monday through Thursday. Listen, it's not gonna be easy. I might not have things to talk about, but I'm still gonna do this Monday through Thursday, whether you idiots like it or not. But it is. He's already setting it up for. I'm not going to really do a show
Like, I'm just going to figure out how to go on and get super chats. Yes.
Sir, I'm afraid Carl from Who Are These Podcasts might be talking about us, sir.
Oh, no. He's right. We are idiots. We don't do a show. We just think we're MLC. But literally, in that clip, he's basically telling you, like, I'm still learning, so don't expect anything. But, we'll learn together. This might take a long time for you to understand that you have to send me super chats, and that will make me happy. But, come see me at Dairy Queen in Cherry Hill, New Jersey. It's going to be fantastic. A lot of Italian jokes. You like Italian humor? Then come see me, Joe Matarese. Just in this clip alone, he brings up the super chats a lot. Like, he loves them. He loves seeing the super chats. It is interesting to, see people who are new to the whole super chat thing and see how their eyes kind of light up when they see super chats. So, and I understand. I get it. Well, listen, we love super chats here. But again, we don't endlessly talk about the super chats either. But
we'd love to, though, sir.
We would love to. But yes, it is very obvious that Joe is motivated by super chats.
Oppenheimer won on that one, but this will all be pretty boring. I don't want to run through this, after talking with Ray, that was more, I think, up our alley here on the super chats, and talking to your super chats will probably be what we want to do.
He's basically like, I did do some show prep, but that's boring, right? I mean, talking to super chat and super chat and the super chats is, yeah, we want to do the super chat with the super chats. He's like hypnotized. Just gonna say super chats.
Talking to the super chats is coming soon on the MLC network.
Yes, but it is. It's so funny. Welcome to the Hackverse, Joe Matarese. Thursday. So like I said, Joe Matarese understands this is not easy. It's not easy for him. He's new to all this, just like Chad. Remember, Chad just started this a year from January. He's never talked to an audience before that. It's all very new to him. But Joe says it's not going to be easy, but I'm still going to go on Monday through Thursday at 7. Like, whether you like it or not, I'm doing it. We're doing it. Super chat, the super chat.
Sure. So, folks.
Yes.
Who would you rather see Joe Matarese partner with for a show? Stuttering John or Opie, sir?
Huh. Probably Opie. Just because Stuttering John won't let like a co-host get much in edgewise unless it's something John doesn't know anything about, like politics. That's why he needs his co-host for the politics show and why he says, I don't need anyone for my regular show. It holds me back. But how come it doesn't hold him back from his political show? If anything, he won't do the political show unless those two other idiots are with him. So I don't see him doing well with the likes of Stuttering John. But I think him and Opie would be pretty good together. Because they would, Opie would say crazy things in a voice. And then Joe would be like, hey, that's pretty good. How'd you do that voice? Hey, did that voice just like come out of you? He'd be like, I don't know. I just do the voice. What do I know? Like, hey, that's pretty good. We should do something with that. Do you think you could give that voice like an Italian accent or something? What were you saying, Ralph?
Brilliant analysis, sir.
Thank you.
Becoming the Phil Hendry show.
Yes. Yes, Phil Hendry. Hendry. But I think Opie would wow Joe Matarese with his incredible impressions. Like, doggy. and then Opie would feel good because Joe Matarese would be talking like, oh man, how did you do that? That was pretty crazy. That was really good. back and forth.
I hope you had fun shooting the shit. I'll be up here again tomorrow night, possibly tomorrow night, a 7 o'clock show. I'm trying to do these Monday through Thursday at 7. It's really hard. It's really hard unless you got something really important to talk about. Something's got to go wrong. Something,
Go with that instinct, Joe. Less is more sometimes. If you have nothing to say, there's no reason to do a show.
Why do you think Tookie only does two shows a week? I don't feel it's important to hear what Tookie has to say every stupid fucking day, like John.
And I then disagree,
you just keep repeating, you keep repeating the same shit. Thank you. Thank you. Thank
you. Week, sir. Mornings thank and you, night.
Thank you. Well, you never know. Could come to that. Could be pimping out family members to take off their clothes for $50 or less.
Looking forward to it, sir.
We never know. We never know.
For you guys to be interested in it, it's got to be like, holy shit, this fucking happened. I am fucking pissed, you know? So that's kind of what's got to happen. And besides that, it's tough. It's tough. All right.
So that's Joe. That's Joe's theme song, where the roaches from John's apartment just chant, Joe, 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 Joe. Just like in the movie. Did you see Joe's apartment?
No.
Yes, really? Sir. Yeah, there's a part where they all chant.
Jerry O'Connell, sir.
Yes! Jerry O'Connell, whose mother?
Taught.
Lester.
Beetlejuice.
Green, you idiot! And then we were supposed to say, also known as...
I thought we were doing the Lester Beetlejuice Green.
No.
Should have rehearsed that better, sir. Rest in peace, Beetlejuice.
Rest in peace, Beetle. What? He's not dead. Is he dead?
No.
Oh, we wanted you to start the rumor, sir.
Ugh. All right. No. Beetlejuice is not dead. Neither is Joe Matarese yet. Does take a lot of prescription pills, I believe. Allegedly. Is that what makes him think he's funny?
No, he's on... No, the pills he's on are like antidepressants, sir. Not fun pills, sir.
Oh.
What's his... What? You
think you're funny if you're not? Because wouldn't you be depressed because you're not funny? So then you take antidepressant pills and they make you think you are funny? What were you saying? Oh, sorry. What, Ralph?
I gotta ask though, just for anybody out there, what is Joe's YouTube channel? Is it Joe Matarese?
Yeah, something like that. I don't know.
He's easy to find. He's not like Stuttering John M.
Look it up.
Yeah, it's not hard to find at all. It's at the Joe Matarese.
Hey, Ray went live.
Stupid.
So stupid.
All right, everyone go watch Ray. I'm done. Tookie's done. We're out of here. It was real fun, but we can't compete with Ray. So, good night, everybody. Love you all more than a friend.
Sit, Eugene. Sit. Good dog.
That's the end of my show. Donk.
You got them this time, sir.
We were supposed to say your mom's, John's mom's box. I forgot about that. Yes, we are back.
Football, sir.
We fooled you. Hacka hacka.
April Fools. April Fools.
I feel like that's going to be bigger than the puncher interview, sir.
Yes. We're doing it. What did we do? We did Dabbler Gossip. We did guy stuff.
Mm-hmm. We jerked off, sir.
We jerked off. We did Chad. We jerked did Joe Matarese. Then we jerked off again. Then we did Joe Matarese. Mm-hmm. It's fantastic. We are doing it. All right. Who else we got? Oh, yeah. We got Opie. We haven't done Opie in so long. This is going to be very... this is going to make Michael Gavin Ali very happy. He's always bugging me to do Opie for some reason. Don't worry, Opie. You'll never lose a fan in Michael Gavin Ali because I think he's listening to you every day. But I had not been. Have you guys been watching Opie at all? We used to be good friends with Opie.
We were great friends with Opie. He said he might have us back one day.
Oh, fantastic. Oh, geez. I'll just wait by the phone.
Yes.
Did he do a walking stream today or yesterday or something?
He does so much, OJ. It is really unfair of you to just, you know, label him as one kind of streamer. I know you just want to call him a sunrise streamer like Cardiff.
Right.
But no, Opie does all the streams now. He does all the different kinds of streaming. He does a walk and talk, just like Joey. who apparently wants to kill himself now, Joey.
What?
He wants to go to Iceland, sir.
He wants to go to Iceland?
Greenland.
Greenland?
Yes, sir.
Is that a joke?
Dick Masterson thing, sir.
Oh, okay. I don't know.
Joey wants to off himself?
That's what people have been telling me. He's been very dark lately. And I guess on a show yesterday morning, the morning show with Kai or KY, whatever that guy's name.
Yeah.
Joey was on. He was very dark, talking about ending it all. And then they took down that show, and I don't think they put it back up. But Joey, just want to say, as your friends, we finally support what you want to do. We support you, Joey.
No, sir. You may not want to say that, sir.
What are you talking about?
We want to retract that statement, sir.
All right. Hacka hacka. We were kidding. But Joey, we hope you're all right. We look forward to meeting you in a little over in about a week. Mm-hmm. WATP Live in Largo. We will prove that Joey either has his real feet or does not.
Did you get your tetanus shot, sir?
It's one of the first things. Yes. Yes, I did. Thank you.
It's important to get vaccinated before meeting Joey C, sir.
That's one of the things I'm going to have him do, though, when we meet him, is have him take off his shoes and his socks, prove that his feet are actually attached to his legs and not by bolts or some kind of screw apparatus, but by bone and muscle and tendons.
Can I make a request for Joey Cesar?
What? Yes.
Joey C, can you wear green socks, please? It'll make it much easier for the photoshops.
Yes, please. Joey, go. Oh man, we should buy him some green socks. Joey, what size socks do you think you are? We'll bring green socks with us.
I think his baby, he wears those like baby socks, sir.
Yeah.
He's just got tiny little.
So what if all his pants were like those pants that have feeties attached to them? And then he just puts those in his shoes so he doesn't have to wear socks? Because they're too confining,
mm-hmm.
because of the blood pressure and the diabetes. Oh, he can't have regular socks.
It's nice to have that no-slip surface
on yes. the bottom
of the socks, too.
Yes!
It's important.
And then he has a little flap on his butt that he can just open up if he has to poop. It's fantastic. All right, so Opie Radio. Back to Opie. How do we get on Joey? But back to Opie Radio. I was up early, yesterday, and it was exciting. Opie had already been on for an hour, and of course, in true Opster fashion, he had to brag about how much he made in the hour.
Person, let's give them a little, yeah, of course it's Ross Dog's Broken Spirit. I made $5 to do this today, thank you. That's it, because people want to know. I made $5. Hit the like on the way out, all right? I'm not promoting anything because it's stupid. Oh, I will promote this, one thing. I started live streaming on the streets of New York again, and I was trying to use the StreamYard app, which allows me to live stream on multiple platforms, but the quality just sucked a you-know-what. TikTok is the best platform for live streaming on the streets of New York City, if you want to know the truth.
Pekka.
But I make literally 4 cents every time I live stream, and I'm trying to make a few bucks doing this.
Bragger. Have you ever heard Opie brag about his finances so much before?
No.
Usually he's telling us how cash poor he is. Now he's bragging about how he made $5 in an hour, and he makes 4 cents on his TikTok videos. It's fantastic. How is this happening? What world, what universe are we living in? Opie is in a multi-million dollar high-rise in New York City talking to 80 people, and I'm in my mom's basement talking to 700 and something. But actually, Opie will let us know that the 80-something people we saw on YouTube, that's an illusion.
I had assumed so, sir.
Because after that $5, see, sometimes, you know, when you have a tip jar, they tell you, hey, put a couple bucks in the tip jar. It encourages others to throw some money in. You know, if they see an empty tip jar, they're like, oh, this guy must suck. He isn't getting any tips. So after Opie displays the $5 he made in the hour, he actually gets an extra 15, which is fantastic. Wow. But then Opie tells us the real number for the listeners. Don't listen to YouTube.
Fivers and likes. Oh, damn. Chuck Ling gave me a tenner on the way out. Have a good ones. Have a goods one, Ope. Thanks for another stream. Oh, Chuck, man. Thank you, brother. Chuck Ling is a good egg. All right. I made $20. That's good. I'll take that. Hey, Ching Lee. How are you? Ching Lee is he's a big-time regular that had to change his YouTube name. No one is going to let Opie go. No, my daughter's sniffly. I had to see if she's all right for school and all that. Wow, a whole 47 watching. My, how far we have fallen. All right, thanks, John.
Apparently, I was being a little generous when I said 80-something people. Apparently, it was 40-something people. But yes, that is what YouTube was saying at the time. So what is the explanation, Ope, sir?
You keep track of my numbers for me. I see 710. I don't know where this giant number's coming from. I'm live streaming on Twitter, Facebook, YouTube, Instagram. And my number right now is it just went up, 712. I don't know where the big chunk of that number's coming from. So whatever. All right. Oh, let me get rid of dumb John.
So when you do the live stream, if you just put your mouse over the number, it'll tell you how many viewers you have in each place. So right now we have like 500. It's right now it tells me we have 732 people. And now people watching YouTube will go, oh, look at Tookie. Tookie's a liar too. Tookie inflates the numbers because there's only 529 people watching on YouTube. But then there's another 202 people watching on X or Twitter. And one lowly person watching on Twitch. So Opie could easily find out where those extra people are coming from. And I think he actually does in this next clip. And so he kind of figures out what's going on. But I still don't know if he really knows,
sir,
what's going on. Yes.
Bad at karate.
Bad at karate.
Yes, sir.
Bad.
That's the one person using Twitch, sir.
Oh, really?
Yes.
That's hilarious. Hello, congratulations.
You win.
Yes, you won. You won, bad at karate. Fantastic. So here, here, Opie talks about how his numbers keep going up, but then he gives us a lower number than the 700. So it's very odd.
This number's going way up. It's 687. It was just over 700. Now it's dipping under 700, but that's a giant number.
I think the literal definition of that is that the numbers are going down, but, you know, potato, potato, as we say here.
Agreed.
Twitter number huge. Oh, wait. Where's Vincent? Vince Scaramuzzo. Twitter number huge every day since last week. Yeah, some Twitter must have done something differently or something. Oh, there's the sun too.
Yeah. So, okay. So apparently all Opie's views are coming from Twitter now. And Opie's like, well, I know it's nothing I did. It's not because I did anything good for a show. So Twitter must be doing something. So he's very confused as to what Twitter did. He's like, there must be something wrong. I'm going to call Twitter and ask them what they're doing because I should not have over 80 something viewers. But yes, he's saying on Twitter he actually has over 600. Now again, I just told you Tookie has 213 people are watching on Twitter right now. Does Opie really get 400 more viewers on Twitter? But then he has
195,000 followers, sir. There's a chance.
Yeah, I guess that's true. But he has 140,000 viewers on YouTube or subscribers, doesn't he?
Yeah, but YouTube subscribers fall off.
Yeah, I don't know. It's so odd, but yes. So apparently, but Opie does. He gets his viewers on Twitter, which is fantastic. The Opster killing it. Not like the rest of you. He is killing it. But yeah, here's the last clip of Opie. Again, Opie is shocked that he has so many viewers because obviously it's not anything he did. There must be some other explanation as to where all these people are coming from. It's like all those other shows that we troll, and then all of a sudden they get like 20 people and they're like, uh-oh, something's not right here. We usually only have 6 people here. We got to block 14 people now.
But lately, right now it's at 733. That's almost 7 times the amount of people watching this than a mere week or two ago. So Twitter obviously changed something. Because according to Vincent Scaramuzzo, most of the numbers coming from Twitter now. So note to self, make sure you live stream on Twitter every morning.
Sir?
Yes.
Am I incorrect in thinking he didn't stream on Twitter before?
Maybe you're right. Maybe he was just doing Facebook because of Facebook stars. Facebook stars are a good way to get Opie and encourage him to keep doing streams.
Yeah, no, I think something is up with Twitter because people in the chat are pointing out, yeah, we usually, you know, we don't get a whole bunch of live viewers on Twitter. And yeah, today.
Oh, is that true?
Yeah.
Okay.
And so we have over 200 right now.
All right, cut this segment out. Cut this whole segment out then. Opie, we apologize. Apparently Twitter did do something. Twitter's inflating the numbers like Rumble. So yeah. There you go.
They are really pushing the video platform, sir.
Oh, is that what's happening?
Well, they really want to become a video platform.
Yay! All right. Well, there you go. There's the Opster. I don't know. I was watching him, and I was pretty shocked that he only had $5 in the whole hour. And then, that whole thing happened, and I thought it was more interesting than I guess it actually is. Because, yeah, apparently our numbers are bigger now, too. So thank you, Twitter. Thank you for fudging the numbers. We appreciate it. Now it feels like it's finally worth the money that we paid you for viewers. Now that you know it's paying off.
You're winning, sir.
Yes, we're all winning. This is fantastic. We have super chats to catch up on. Before we do, the final person of the day, the mighty Boss Man Jack. Again, Boss Man Jack is now addicted to roulette. And I don't want to spoil it for anyone. But I think he comes out pretty good in this one. I think he stops while he's ahead. No, he does not. Oh. But it's quite the roller coaster journey. And we will take that together. And if any of you have to leave, because I know it's late, please get the fuck out of here. Thank Gordon, you. What?
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Gordon Shumway, $2. Chad looks like Mimi from Drew Carey. Yeah, we did that one. Thank you, Gordon. I do not have the two. Oh, no, I do.
2-2-2-2-2-Tookie World Order. T-W-O.
See, I didn't even think I had it, but I did. There you go. Thank you, Gordon. Dang Lizard, €2. It's DNA level C, the lowest quality. Yes. When it just sits in the condom. It turns. It's not. You know, it's not a chunky, cloudy goodness anymore. It's just gross, loose, cumsies.
Delicious, sir.
Delicious. Oh, I know. That's what I was just thinking about food. Sorry. I was distracted. Kinky Logo, $2. Breaking Dabbler Gossip. Check Discord. Uh-oh. Are you serious?
Spy report.
This is my checking Discord music. Do 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 do. Let's see.
Can I suggest the Kinky Loco when we're doing Tookie show, send the gossip to Cardiff or OJ. When we're doing Cardiff show, send the gossip to.
Whoa! Tookie. Holy shit! This is not. Is this real?
Oh no.
This is a spy report. This is Dabbler Gossip.
So excited.
Hold on. I need to save this image. Kinky Logo. Am I really looking at this? Is this like legal? Can I like announce this?
Oh no. Kinky, send it to me. Let me make a call.
Hold on. So if someone. If someone discovers they have an illegitimate daughter, I mean, that's public, right? I mean, it's on Instagram. All right, hold on. Here we go. All right. Hold on, hold on. Sons of bitches. I gotta get the, I gotta get it now, and I gotta throw it into Oh, this is horrible.
Oh, mm-hmm.
He was related to Rachel Dolezal.
Whoop, that's it.
Not me.
Oh, mm-hmm.
He was related to Rachel Dolezal. Whoop, that's it. Just fart.
No,
we heard it, sir.
No, it was not. You're disgusting. Fuck. Why is it not working? Hold on. Hold on. Hold
doing
on.
Doing it.
Save image.
We're doing it.
Wait, but this is from 2021. Wait, hold on, Kinky. Kinky, look at this from 2021. I'm trying to understand what I'm looking at. All right, I guess if it's from 2021, that even means we should be more inclined to show it, I guess, right?
Sure.
I don't know what it is, sir.
All right, here we go. I feel like people might know this already. I don't know. All right. So appears one Army major discovered in 2021 that he has a 27-year-old daughter?
Hmm.
What am I looking at? Tomorrow, I will take my daughter that I recently found out about to get her last name changed to Ojeda. For 27 years, we never knew each other existed. Thanks to Ancestry.com test, our paths crossed. I wasn't there the first 27 years, but I guarantee I will be there for the rest. Tomorrow will be a great day.
Hmm.
But this is old. Like, this says 2021. Is this Dabbler gossip?
He still might curb stomp you for it, sir.
Yes. He's going to curb stomp us.
Well, I know, John was very mad at Vince for giving out the Army Major's name, sir.
Yes. Well, his wife's name,
his
right?
His wife's name, sorry, sir.
Yes. And then Brian Karam didn't even know what was going on because he was so zooted that he didn't even care, right? He's all zooted on fucking Booger Sugar or whatever. But yeah, again, Kinky Loco. Kinky Loco is saying this is Dabbler gossip. I trust Kinky Loco. But again, looking at the date, I mean, this is 2 years ago or 3 years ago almost. But I guess I did not know. Did anyone else know that Army Major had a daughter he did not know about for 27 years?
No.
The problem is if I knew, sir, I don't think I would have cared.
Right.
Yeah, I don't care either. But yeah, if someone tells me they have Dabbler gossip, I have to look into it, and I will never reveal our sources.
It's your duty, sir.
Kinky Loco. Thank you for sourcing that to me, Kinky Loco.
I have more Dabbler gossip, sir.
Admiral Orbani, thank you for the $2. Chad purchased the hat from AliExpress. Hashtag sweatshop. Yes. Listen, I'm all for sweatshops as long as the Tukey costume looks like the costume in the picture. If I get something that looks nothing like that costume, I'm going to shit in the box and send it back to China. Hoi.
It always costs more to send back, sir.
Yeah, I don't care. It'll be worth it to send back a box of my shit. And then I'll go, oh, I'm sorry. You know what it is? I ordered that box that you're supposed to shit in and then send it back, and they tell you if you have ass cancer, and I must have gotten the boxes mixed up. I'm sorry, Mr. Hadomoshi.
What if you start a worldwide pandemic, sir, where chunks of your hair fall out all over the world?
Yes. But yes, I will be they better not fuck me over. AliExpress, this is a warning. If you fuck Tukey over, what?
You pay with PayPal, sir?
No, I use a credit card.
PayPal's so probably better, sir.
Why? Credit cards are always the best when you feel like something. Because then credit cards, you'll always get the money back. If it's something linked to your bank, then you're like fucked. But yeah, maybe. No, PayPal. Yeah, PayPal's like linked to your bank. And how could PayPal be best?
I don't know. I thought they'd be more protective. I don't know why.
So. No, I don't know. No, all I know is like, you know, anytime you're like, get fucked over with your credit card, they automatically go, yep, you're not responsible for this. Don't worry about it. And I was like, yes. John's Neglected Cat gifted 5 BeDabblin Network memberships. Thank you, John's Neglected Cat. How much did that cost you? So figure that out. When you that way you could do gifted memberships. What were you gonna say, Ralph?
What?
Oh, I thought you were about to say something.
Nope. No, sir.
Cookie for Tookie, $2 towards Tookie's chin thumb surgery. Hashtag boom shakalaka. Thank you, Cookie for Tookie. I'm so angry. Underdog, $5. Thank you. I am Underdog, and you are not an airwave polluter. Let me sing to you in Latin. Yes, please. Please do. Airwave polluter. I am not the Underdog lady. I am actually, when I'm doing my interpretive dance, I am Underdog. Dang Lizard, thank you for the two. Oh, wait, what voice am I doing? Let me reset. Oh, 3, 2.
Oh, mm-hmm.
He was related to Rachel Dolezal.
Whoop, that's it.
You just fart.
It is. If I've ever, you know, when have you ever heard of someone calling farting cracking a rat?
No.
No, but that is the sound.
Was that right?
That's the first. Yes, that's the first fart I've ever like. That is a fart I would imagine if they said cracking a rat. But yes, you never heard crack a rat.
No,
it's gross. It's disgusting. But they do say it. They say it in another country known as Delaware. Dang Lizard, thank you for the €2. A case of Saint John dispensing his karmic justice. Yes. Agreed. Cookie for Tookie, thank you for another $2. For Tookie's eye patch and chin toupee, hashtag save Tookie. I know. Tookie's falling apart. APAR 199, all makes sense. Tookie farts on cam, now cancer. Yes. Tookie has cancer. Sean, thank you for gifting 5 BeDabbler Network memberships. I appreciate that, Sean. I hope you are well, my friend. Sean was a beloved chatter who was hanging out with Tookie and Melton and Flimsy and Mario movie star Fingernails. Sean was the best. Sean was part of our team, our elite platoon team that would go into situations undetected, gather intel, and then come back with the intel. So thank you, Sean.
Sir, is it possible that you caught something in Atlantic City that's causing this?
Possibly. I wonder how long it's been there and I didn't notice. God,
I'll have to review the video or the show from earlier, see if it was gone.
Oh, and cigarettes. Sean had tons of cigarettes. It was wonderful. Thank you for the cigarettes, Sean. Carl's Frosted Tips, $2. Love you, Tookie, as a friend. Stuttering John is a gay. Yay! Yes, he is. I mean, I don't know. That's what they tell me, but whatever.
John Gay is tainted by your chin, sir.
I'm going to hide it behind the super chats. John Q Public, $4.99. Testicular cancer has one of the highest survival rates. Oh, that's fantastic. I'd have to imagine it'd be pretty obvious too, right? Like, wouldn't you feel it if you were like just washing your nuts? Or do you have to really get in there and like...
Who washes their nuts? Sir?
Shut up. You don't wash your nuts. Now, if you said feet, I understand. Yes. Who washes their feet? I mean, come on. Everything runs down. It's like washing a car. You start from the top, and then everything, you know, all goes and cleans the other areas. But do you have to, like, take your testicles and, like, put them in between your thumb and, like, forefinger and, like, oh, lumpy.
What you have to do, sir,
lumpy.
Lay a mirror down on the floor.
What?
Lay a mirror down on the floor.
Yep.
You squat over the mirror naked.
Okay. Whoa! Oh, that's disgusting. Oh, it's a giant hole.
Then you take a picture of that mirror and send it to me, sir.
And an arm. Okay, no problem. Delco Chris, $2. Is Tookie from Etsy? Clone up. No, Tookie's from eBay. From a guy who made puppets. And then I emailed that guy and told him I wanted another Tookie, for instance, just like this. And the motherfucker told me, like, I don't have materials. I can't fund the materials for that puppet. I stopped production on that puppet. I was like, fuck, dickhead. Adam Carbon, $5. Got here late. Anyone else notice Tukey has a massive bald spot? Oh no, it's noticeable. Everyone sees it. Maybe buy a mini pair of rubber boobers to place over the glaring bald spot. What are rubber boobers? Rubber boobers. Is that a Canada thing?
Maybe like Bedorable's boobers.
Oh, yes. Oh, tits on your chin.
Yes.
Yes.
Like Ray DeVito has an ass on his chin.
Yes.
You can have tits on your chin.
Well, yeah, Ray DeVito. He does have a butt.
Sir?
Yes.
The JT wants everyone to know that it was him who told Kinky Loco the Ojeda news was tomorrow. I don't know what that means. He just said he's insisting that I tell everyone.
The Ojeda news was tomorrow?
Yes.
JT thought, okay, yeah, because they didn't look at the date. So JT thought that that was happening tomorrow. Like he was going to go meet his daughter for the first time tomorrow. JT, you're an idiot. You're a retard. And that's why I love you. So thank you. Thank you for that Dabbler gossip. 3 years too late. Better late than never.
That's right.
But again, hey, it's news. If you don't know it, it's news to you. Because that's our motto here. It's news you can use for the Jews. Gordon Shumway, thank you for the $2.
Skull. For the Jews, sir.
What?
Is the news for the Jews or it's news you can use in a situation with Jews? Your tagline is confusing, sir.
No, it is news you can use for the Jews.
So it's the news is for the Jews.
Well, you can use it
for the Jews.
For the Jews.
No, that makes sense now, sir.
Use it for the Jews. It.
Thank you, sir.
Gordon Shumway, thank you for the $2. Skull to Aunt Butchie. Tukey may have cancer of the eyes. Or the ass. Or the ass. Your big brown ass.
Hope not, sir.
Daniel Poon, Poony, $2. Knowing is half the battle. The rest is guy stuff. Of course. The more you know, guy stuff. Who can forget this? Member for 5 months. Tukey's melting. Don't look directly into the arc. Yes. I do know what you're talking about. I don't think I've seen that movie, but I do know that.
You haven't seen Raiders of the Lost Ark for crying out loud.
No, but I saw that newer one. It was horrible.
Why?
The one with, because I think they just made one. But the one a couple of years ago.
Oh, with Shia LaBeouf.
Shia LaBeouf. It was pretty great. No, it sucked. I don't know. I don't know if that was the right movie to come in on for the franchise.
Definitely not, sir.
Kind of ruined it for Tukey. Red 473, $5. Panhandling for super chats is pathetic. Totally shows when these bums hit rock bottom. By the way, here's some money. Hacka hacka. Thank you, Red. We appreciate it. That's going to the Tukey Repair Fund. We hit the goal. I know we definitely hit the goal. And that means, as everyone knows, we have to do it because we hit the goal.
Oh, Ray's gay, Ray's gay, Ray's gay, Ray's gay. Ray's gay, Ray's gay. Ray's gay, Ray's gay, Ray's gay, Ray's gay. Ray's gay, Ray's gay.
That's right. We have officially hit overtime. And we don't even have to worry about going over Pat Dixon's time because Pat Dixon is not on tonight. Oh, well, maybe he's on somewhere.
That's where all the Twitter viewers came from, sir.
Yes.
Actually, I figured that out, sir.
Yes. Thank you, Pat Dixon, for losing your channel today and giving us more viewers. But no, seriously, go follow Pat on Twitter at Pat Dixon. Actually, someone go follow him now. See if he posted anything about if he's doing a show tonight.
Yeah, he's got to get onto Rumble. I'll subscribe and watch him on Rumble if he goes over there. I'm sure a lot of people will follow him over there.
Rumble, Patreon.
Yeah.
They're probably the easiest ones not to get taken off of. But it sucks. It's fucking bullshit. But what can you do? Tukey not Tookie, YouTube owns the fucking, you know, they are the Boardwalk and Park Place of live streaming.
Maybe Pat should get a mask gimmick and come on as a different character so they don't know it's him.
Well, I think it's the name that they're sending money to that's the issue.
Yes.
Well, there's ways around that.
That's true. Well, he is going live at 12:30 a.m. on Censored TV for a free stream tonight, sir.
Oh, wow. Yeah. Oh, so that's huge.
That's big.
So, Censored.TV, you can watch Pat Dixon live tonight at midnight. So a little less than an hour, or what did he say, 12 or 12:30?
12:30, sir.
Okay, so a little more than an hour from now. So right after Tookie, right after Tookie, you get a snack, maybe get a shower in before bed, and then you can fall asleep to the soothing sounds of Pat Dixon. It's fantastic. So yeah, go follow him on censored.tv. That's Gavin McGinnis's platform. That's his compound media, if you will. And yeah, go check out Pat. Because Pat's a good guy. He's a friend of the show. He's a friend of Tookie. It was really... And actually, I found out because YouTube sent me an email. And it just said, your membership has been paused. But it didn't say for what channel. So then I had to go into my memberships. And it showed... just a blank channel, and I still had to like figure out what channel was gone. And then I realized, oh wait, I'm a member of Pat's channel. So then I looked for Pat, and yeah, it was gone. It was all gone.
Oh, you know what, Tookie? I was gonna be on the show this week.
YouTube knew it. They just wanted to fuck you over again, OJ. Anyway, that YouTube can fuck OJ over, they love to do it. But a good question came up today. Pat has money owed to him from last month and some from this month. Will Pat get that money? OJ, you never got your money, right?
No, never did. And
did you complete all the steps? Like you sent back the code they mailed to you and all that crap?
Oh, yeah. I'm assuming once it gets reinstated that it's going to be there. If not, then... I'll let you know. But yeah, I'm assuming it's going to be there and they'll...
That's crazy. But that seems like thievery. Like it seems like they robbed you of your money. Like you made that money.
Right.
And it should be, yes, okay, you're fired. But...
Or YouTube should refund it.
Or refund it to the people who sent it. Yes, that's a possibility too. It doesn't sound like that's happening either. So where the fuck is this money? Where is it just sitting somewhere? Is it collecting interest?
In Pat's case, I could see them seizing it, sir. Because again, they believe he never should have been on the platform to begin with.
Right. But I mean, they could say the same thing about OJ because apparently they think he crossed some kind of line or he broke a rule. So, technically they could go, well, we had to shut down your monetization because of this, which means you also don't get the money. Like, I don't get it. Where does it end?
Right.
I believe in OJ's case, they just don't want him to continue to monetize.
Let me take a wild guess, too, and predict that YouTube took their 30% out of whatever OJ was owed. So I'm sure YouTube got that money good and quick. Mm-hmm. But, yeah,
OJ... You made them the company they are today, sir. They couldn't have bought all those new servers without that OJ money.
Yes, without that 2860.
Well, I made a PayPal and a Venmo, so I've been getting a couple donations that way, so I'm not... I'm not even worried about it, but yeah, that money is kind of shitty. If he made all that money and they're not giving it to him, that's thievery.
Isn't your Venmo? I like dicks in my butt.
Yes. Is it? You should plug your Venmo.
That's what I'm trying to get you to do here.
Oh, Obnoxious John. That's it. Obnoxious John. I wasn't trying to plug it.
And I'll put it on Tookie Soup too, so people know if they want to donate to OJ, you can donate to OJ at Obnoxious John on Venmo.
And PayPal.
And PayPal. There you go. Lucky. And Disney Bucks, Burger King Cash, Starbucks Bucks.
I figured out what's happening with Twitter, sir.
Cops are coming. What?
So if you go to Twitter now, it's showing that there's 270 views Like StreamYard is counting the views. Like something's weird on Twitter's side, and StreamYard's counting the views as live viewers.
Oh, interesting. So that 270 whatever will never go down.
It never. It just. I've been watching. It keeps going up one.
Okay.
One.
Interesting.
Like, yeah.
Oh really? Oh wow. So they really make you think you have more people than you actually do.
Weird. So that's what's happening to Opie.
And that's what's happened to Opie. He's just getting like, yeah, whoever like kind of stumbles 20, on.
20 people are staying for an hour and it just keeps climbing.
Interesting. Crazy. It's crazy how all these companies are trying to make their numbers look good. And meanwhile, it's like, yeah, there's still nobody. We're talking to nobody. But it's fantastic because we're still talking to more than Chad and literally almost all the other show. I mean, you know, it's weird. It's so stupid. All right. Uncle Paul Melendez, not Menendez, $4.99. Wait a minute. I remember little. Oh, wait. Sure. Wait a minute. I remember little Joey. He would always tattle on me and my kids when we would play old Frickle Frackle. Sure. I remember little Joey. Get your clothes on. Your mom's here. But thank you, Uncle Paul. Appreciate it. It's Uncle Paul Hargis, not Melendez. So thorough, Joe Burrow, $1.99. You can do it, Joey. Yes, see, Joey? You have a lot of people who have your back. Everyone thinks you can accomplish whatever you put your mind to. Especially, you know, that one thing. John's Daughter's Glands, thank you for being a member for 6 months. Just got home. Can you start over? Thanks. No. Just rewind. Oh, and listen at 2x the speed and you'll probably catch up. But until then, no, we cannot. All right, we're all caught up?
We are.
That's fantastic.
Good job, sir.
Thank you. Good job to you. All right. I have a ton of Bossman Jack clips, but I'm going to be very picky. Shut up. I know that's very sarcastic.
No, it's not, sir. I like Bossman
Jack. Oh, do you? I just figured you probably want to go to bed.
I hate him, but I love him.
I know. Listen, Bossman is, I know he's an acquired taste. I seem to really relate. This is probably the locale I relate to the most. I don't drink. I don't do drugs. I love the idea of winning money by playing carnival games. It's something that has always been near and dear to Tookie's heart. And the fact that we live in an age where you can do it on your phone or your computer, where you can literally be butt naked all day, gambling money. What a time to be alive. So like I said, Bossman Jack, we've seen him play all kinds of games. We've seen
him gambling
play.
Now, sir.
What?
Are you gambling at this moment?
Yes.
I knew it. On your phone, sir?
Yes. I'm playing poker and losing terribly. But, okay, so we've seen Bossman Jack play every kind of digital gambling known to man. High-low type games, fake dice games, fake wheels.
Plinko is my favorite.
Plinko. Fake Plinko. This is roulette. I don't feel like we've ever really seen him play roulette, but I think this is going to be his game. So here he is playing some roulette.
Oh my God, I hit it again. Oh my fucking God. No fucking way, dude.
So we're starting with $136. He's making $2 bets. And on this particular night, green zero seems to be hitting a lot.
Oh my God, I hit again. What the fuck, dude? Oh my God. Oh my God, start with $2. Oh my God, that was $4. I upped it to $4. Oh my fucking God.
Those three consecutive.
Oh, there it is. I hit the.
It was like, it was three out of, I think, five spins. He hit, yeah, green zero. But unfortunately, he only had $2 and then $4 bets. Now he's up to, his total there that says eight, that's how much he has out on the table. So right now, each chip value is $1. So he has like four. He has $4 on O and then $4 on the number four, which also just hit. So he's gone from $136 to $250.
Fucking four. Oh my God.
Haven't we seen this gentleman bet thousands of dollars on a roll of a dice, sir?
Yes, I know. And now a $2 bet is getting him jacked. That's what I'm saying. It'll never be enough money. The dollar value doesn't mean anything.
He's got a new door, huh, Tookie?
Just the juice. Yes, but as you can see, and I think we showed this a couple of weeks ago. By the way, thank you to Colonel Rat, one of the Boss Man Clippers. Thank you to Colonel Rat. He's the one who clipped this. He does have a new door, but remember we saw them bring it in, and it's just the door.
Oh, they okay.
It's not one of those hanging doors, and it doesn't fit. So now it's just like there.
So they never fixed it. They just put that door up.
And that was like 2 weeks ago.
Right.
So it's there, but they haven't installed it. But what it is doing is blocking the giant hole that's in his wall. So I guess it's doing something. But here we go. Here's more Bossman Jack playing roulette.
Oh, my God. I hit again.
Another zero. Literally, zero has come out about four or five times in the last, I would say, seven or eight spins, which is unheard of. Like, it's just.
No, that doesn't make sense, sir.
Doesn't make sense. None of this makes sense. It's all digital. Anyone can just type in whatever they want it to be. Like, I don't get it.
Oh, you know what? When zero and double zero come up, sir, every time?
When?
When I'm down to my last 50 bucks, I just say I'm throwing it on black.
Yes, of course.
And red's been on a run for like 10 in a row.
Yes.
And I just say, fuck this. My last 50 on black and then double zero.
100%. No, I'm with you. Yes, anytime. Yeah, when I tend to bet the colors as well. Yes, zero or double zero. This wheel, however, only has the single zero. And I don't think there is... There must be a red and black bet, but I don't think he ever bets it. He's just going strictly with numbers.
No fucking way, dude. Oh my God, it hit again.
It hit again.
Yeah, sir, it only looks like the only optional bets are the lines.
Yeah, the lines. You could bet. Yeah, you could bet a whole row or numbers, or you could probably put it in between numbers and stuff like that. But you can't, for some reason, bet colors.
What the fuck, dude? Oh my God. Oh my God. Start with $2. Oh my God. That was $4.
Again, why would zero keep coming out like this? It's insane. But it's crazy because normally he would be upping his bets and putting way more out there. But he left some money on the table with his normal betting here because, yeah, zero just came out literally like six or seven times in 12 spins.
Up to the $4. Oh my fucking God. Oh, there it is! I hit the fucking four. Oh my God.
But again, he's only up $110 since we started that clip. So, I mean, he's winning.
He should be 35 to 1 or 37 to 1, whatever it is.
Yeah, on four.
Like when you hit it straight up.
Yeah, what was he winning?
It doesn't seem like he's winning much at all. It's almost like it's just 1 to 1 roulette.
No, it can't be. No, he's definitely getting odds, but you're right. I think it's it must be less odds than what the normal 36 to 1. But why would it? Why? Because there's still, it looks like there's still 36 numbers.
Oh, yeah, that is very strange. You hit straight up like that. You're.
Mm-hmm. I'll try and pay attention. The problem is you don't know what he has on each number. It only tells you the total that he has out on the table. So let's see what happened here.
Oh my God!
So there, he had $50 on the table, but how many did he have on that actual zero? Okay, so it says 1B, which is 1 million. So, okay, we can figure this out. So each chip is a value of a dollar, but for some reason, it says 10 or 100 million on the chip. Do you see that?
Yeah, 1 billion, 400 million.
So if he has 1 billion, that means he has $10 on the zero, right? So he had 360 with a $50 bet, but he has $10 on the zero. So he should win, like $360, right?
Yeah.
Oh my!
That's what he won. So it was real. Okay. Well, it was right. Okay, cool. I'm glad we did that. Yes. So it is 36-1 odds.
God! Zero! Oh my God! $720. Oh my gosh. One more 50. Oh my God! 11! Oh my gosh! Oh my fucking God!
So now, as you can see, before he only had a couple of bucks on, literally only two numbers, 0 and 4. But now he's spaced out the table a bit, and he's got some cash. He's got mostly $3, $4. Like, I don't know why they say 400 million. Like, just say fucking $4. But so he's got mostly $3, $4, but double zero, he's $10 on. Or just single zero, sorry. Which, of course, came out against. So now he is up to $1,328.
Oh, zero! Oh, my gosh, dude. Oh, my gosh, dude. Oh, my God. Oh.
If I was his parents, I'd go, shut the fuck up. You're going to lose it in literally 30 seconds, you fucking idiot. I wish I was his parents. Well, I don't. But just for that reason, just so I could be the one yelling at... Because I can't imagine how these parents just don't come in his room constantly and go, get the fuck out. Get a job. Do something. Get right. the fuck out of here. All you do is yell about how you win, and then fucking literally 2 minutes later, you talk about how you want to kill yourself.
Oh, my God. Oh, my fucking God. Oh, my God. $1,500. Oh, my fucking God. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. All-time high. All-time high. Oh my God! Oh my gosh! I'm out! I'm out! I'm fucking out! Oh my gosh, dude!
So he has turned $136 into $2,462. Again, he is an incredible gambler because he does. He puts a lot of money out there. So when he finally does hit, it looks like, holy shit, he's doing pretty good. Look at that. But he just keeps upping and putting more money out there, and I don't want to spoil it, but things get better. Yay!
Oh, my gosh, dude. $2,400. Oh, my fucking God.
But they do. They seriously, they keep getting better for him in these clips. And you really think, like, oh, maybe this is the one. This is the time when he's going to fucking, he's going to cash out. He's going to be good. Things are going to work for him. He's going to get that car he's always talking about. He's going to get an apartment. These are the kind of things he talks about when he hits it big. He has to talk about it fast, though, because if he doesn't talk about it fast, normally the money is all gone in the next 5 minutes. So it doesn't make sense when he talks about, yo, I'm going to buy a new whip. I'm going to get my own apartment. Yeah, I've been looking at places. It's like, but you just lost $10,000. How are you going to get that stuff now? But here we go. Here's more Boss Man.
Come on. Down to 2K. That's it. I'm serious.
All right. So he's serious. Now he has 2162, and he says, if I get to 2K, if I lose that $162, I'm done. I am done. I am out. Let's see if he can do it.
Come on. Last one. Oh, zero. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh my fucking God! Oh my fucking God! Oh my fucking God! Oh my fucking God! Oh my fucking God, dude! Oh my fucking God, dude!
Oh my fucking God, dude!
Somebody superimpose that on like a porno scene.
Yes. Well. So, was that the one that I pulled? Oh no, he does it again. Oh, there's so many clips here, and I don't know what to play. I'm going to jump to this clip because I think he does that here again. And he might have banked some money at this point. So he actually does put $7,000 away at some point. But I don't know if it's on this clip.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. I'm up 2K already. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. I hit again. Oh, my God, I hit again! Oh, my God. I thought that one hit. Oh, my gosh! Dude, oh, my gosh. Oh, my gosh. What the fuck, dude? What the fuck? What is going on?
Oh, it's all he's been talked to.
What? Oh, he's been talked to?
How gentle he was pounding that chair.
Yes. Yes. So I believe in one of my other clips, he did get up to like $7,000, and I think he cashed it out. Like he put it in the vault, as he says. So that's kind of money that he will later withdraw, but he puts it in the vault to kind of collect and make sure he doesn't play with, which of course he always takes it out of the vault and plays with eventually. But I skipped a couple of clips because we have so many.
Did he always have a folding chair?
No, I believe he slammed his regular chair. He broke his chair. So now he is in a folding chair. Yes, you're absolutely right. Thank you, Ralph. I can't keep up with Bossman Jack. He goes on literally like over 10 times a day. There's so much material with Bossman Jack. It's almost impossible. But basically, this is a story about how he won $10,000 twice in
OJ calls him the Shuli Network of gambling shows.
The Shuli, yes. He is the Shuli Network of gambling shows. It's a great way to put it.
Oh my fucking God. Oh my God, this hit again. Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God.
So I thought that was pretty great. So now we have a new video drop. Anytime something amazing happens, we should play this.
Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God.
It's fantastic. He's literally like having a seizure or something. But yeah, Bossman Jack. So now he is up to about $5,000. Again, I think it's very possible that he did take out $7,000 before this $5,000, because this is a big long roller coaster ride. But like I said, I skipped a bunch of clips because I just had so many clips of basically just him winning, him losing, him winning, him losing. But now we get a little more into his roulette story here.
Oh my God, that is one of my numbers. Oh my God. Oh my God, that's not one of my numbers. Come on. I keep getting confused with normal numbers.
Now he's even getting excited with numbers that come out that aren't even his. That's how much his numbers keep hitting that he is actually excited when any number comes out because he figures, oh, I must have it. I keep hitting. Like, this is great. I can't lose. Oops.
Confused with normal numbers. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh, they hit. Oh my
God. I was going to say, you should put some money on that 26 right next to the zero. That one's coming out a bunch of times as well.
God, I'm at 4,800. Come on. Oh my God, 5,600. Oh my fucking God. 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 Oh my fucking God, dude. Oh my gosh, bro.
So he hit for over. So now he has over $7,000. As you can see, he's betting $580 every spin. So he has to hope one of his numbers hits. Because every time one of his numbers doesn't hit, he loses half a grand. More than half a grand.
No way! No way! Oh my God! Oh my God, dude! Oh my God, dude! Oh my God, dude! Oh my gosh, dude! Oh my gosh, dude! Oh my gosh, dude! Oh my God! Take it! Oh my God!
All right, so he's over 10K, and you would go, okay, that's probably the number he wanted to hit. Now he's done for the night. He's going to go, you know, go to bed.
Buy a car.
Buy a car. Not a car,
but you could buy a car.
But think about it. I mean, he literally started this game with $130, whatever we were watching, right?
Stop justifying it in your head, sir.
But what is the number? Like, what is the number he's looking for to stop? If it's not $10,000, what is it? Is it $100,000? Is it $50,000? What is it? $5 million?
There is no limit. I think you keep.
No, I know what the number is, sir.
What?
It's $10,068.54, sir.
Oh man, it's
so close.
Oh, I really feel like that penny is gonna fuck him over. So here he is hyperventilating. I'm assuming because he knows in about 2 minutes he's gonna lose all this money.
How old is this guy again?
He's like 28. He's close to 30.
Wow.
He's either 30 or in his late 20s.
Wow.
But yeah, he's way too old to be doing this in his parents' house, but he's doing it. We're doing it.
We're doing it.
All right, so in that clip, you could see Boss Man Jack putting his hands over his face. And if we zoom in and enhance, we see another characteristic that a lot of these guys seem to have. And that is filthy, filthy black fingernails. I don't think Boss Man Jack showers. I don't think he bathes because he spends all his time gambling.
Oh.
I also don't think he does a lot of gardening, sir.
Yeah, right?
Where did that come from?
He doesn't have a car to work on. At least, if someone was like, yeah, well, he's a mechanic all day, and then he comes home and gambles all night, then I would go, oh, okay, I get it. But look at how black his fingers, everything. It's ridiculous. And he's just rubbing them all over his face.
Wow.
So we could use that video clip too. Might throw that in somewhere. So now, okay, so he has $10,000. Life is good, right?
Couldn't be better, sir.
Life couldn't be better. This is it. It's where he turned. This is the turn. I assume this is the turn that everyone's always talking about. Doom. He's always talking about the turn. 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 But yes, I believe the turn is coming up.
Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. All right, last. Oh my God, I won again. Oh my God. Oh my God. I just won again. Oh my God.
Pest is saying that's from meth and crack pipes. Oh yeah. He does like to do crack. Or he has done crack. I don't know if he like. I mean, I'm sure once you do crack, you like to do crack. And I think there have been some meth allegations as well. But yeah, people in the chat know about that kind of stuff way better than Tookie.
Oh my God. Okay, chill out. Chill out. Come on. Okay, last one, I'm out.
He's not out.
Fuck.
And now he's lost like five spins in a row.
Yeah! Oh my.
Company hit. He hit. He's over 10. He's actually at 10,100. So 10,100 isn't enough.
Oh my God. Oh.
All right. So that was that clip. But yeah, I mean, I'm like, God damn it. If I won literally over $9,000 on roulette in that amount of time, because like this was all like straight, like, this isn't like over a period of a couple of days. This is a period of like 10 minutes.
Right.
It's insanity.
Let's be honest, sir.
Last one.
Yes.
You would just blow it on something stupid anyway.
Yes, I would blow it on something stupid, but I would buy 10
dinosaur statue for your backyard.
Yes. Or I'd buy 1,000 green Tookie costumes.
Oh my God. Oh my gosh. Oh no. Oh my God, that hit. Oh my God, that hit.
Now he doesn't even know when he wins.
Oh my God, that did not hit. Fuck. Oh my God. Come on.
God damn this stupid music.
Fuck.
All right, now he is down.
Oh my God.
To 5,000. He's lost half of it.
Fuck.
In about six spins. I would say the last six spins he hasn't hit. Did he just drop the percent? Yeah, he just dropped it from 580 to 290 per spin.
Okay.
He's under 500. What was that?
He'll never catch up that way.
Right. Yes, you got to keep upping your bets. Now he is. But look at this. Literally in like seven or eight spins, he's gone from over $10,000 to $3,738. And you know, like a normal person would go, okay, all right, okay, I had fun. But holy shit, I literally lost like $6,000 in six spins. I still have $3,700. Let's let it ride.
Oh, no.
Who doesn't bet seven?
Oh my God. Oh my God, it's not even a number. Oh my God, I thought I hit that.
10 isn't a number. How did that come out? Now things are coming out that aren't even numbers.
Oh my God. Oh my God, I really just lost thinking.
under. He is now, he has $580 on the table and $1,478. He's literally lost over $8,500 in about 12 spins.
I'm a fucking idiot. Oh my God, hit one. Please, dude, what a fucking ripoff. Oh my God. I just lost.
So now that he's down to his last $300, he finally leaves, which makes no sense to me.
$10,000, dude. Oh my God. What am I doing?
Yes. We ask ourselves this. You are entertaining the masses, boss man. You are sacrificing yourself for the entertainment of so many others. But yes, so he just continues to lose. See what this clip is. Oh, this is him putting it all on zero.
Oh my gosh, dude! Wow! Do you know how much that would have paid?
So he put $300 on zero, and of course, 26 came out, which is conveniently right next to the zero. But yeah, he would have won about $9,000 right there.
Wow.
Which still would have been less than what he had. Isn't that crazy? He would have been so excited to win that $9,000, but in theory, he still was down. So that $9,000, he'd still be chasing whatever number he's looking for.
9,000 on zero, sir.
Then he put 9,000 on zero, exactly. So, yeah, boss man, let's go to the last clip because I think you get the sense. He actually does that twice. He gets it up to $10,000 twice in this one night, and he ended up losing it all both times. So in theory, he lost about $20,000 in one night. I mean, not that he ever had it, but at one point he had $10,000, lost all that, took some more money, got it up to $10,000, lost all that again, and this is the last clip of the night. Here we go.
It's fucked up, dude. They give and take, man. Oh my God, dude. Fuck my life, dude. Oh my God, I'm so close to breaking my computer right now, dude. I'm so close to breaking my computer, dude.
But then you can't gamble.
I mean everything. I want everything to end, dude. I need everything to end, man. You know, that was a good fucking day, dude.
Oh, boss man. He hates it. But this was a couple of days ago. He has streamed a shit ton more time, so I'm assuming he's okay. He's fine. Fuck my life. Fuck my life, dude. Fucking hate everything. Smash everything. But yes, that was a very, very observant of you, Ralph. He did smash his chair. Maybe I'll try and get that clip for Saturday or something. We can watch him smash his chair, but he did. He smashed his chair. He broke his chair. So he's now in a folding chair. And of course, anytime we do a segment on Boss Man Jack, we have to say, remember, if you or someone you know has a gambling problem, to call 1-800-GAMBLER. Bet with your head, not over it.
Bet with your head. No over it.
The number was blocked out because of the banner. The number is kind of the most important thing. 1-800-GAMBLER.
Bet with your head. No over it.
It's fantastic. We're doing it. Regret.
When do you think Bossman Jack's sporting goods store is going to get busted out, sir?
Bossman Jack's sporting goods store. I believe that has happened many, many times over. And he does not own that store anymore. Can't even wash his hands. How the hell is he going to own a sporting goods store? Regretta Melendez, $2. Finally, my mom betted on black. Oh.
Regretta. Stop.
Betted is... All right. All right, Greta. All right, Regretta. Here's the thing. Betted is not a word. All right? It's embarrassing that you even wrote that. All right? Twisted Trucker, $2. The Brat Kid in Over the Top is named Mike Hawk. I feel like I've seen that before. I think I've been sent that before.
Mike
That's
Hawk.
Fascinating. That is big news.
Do you like Mike Hawk?
Spy Report.
I love Mike Cock.
Spy Report. Spy Report.
Big news.
You're not the only one, sir.
No, I'm not. We all do. All right, is that it?
Yeah.
Fantastic. This is a fun show. This is a long show. Thank you, everybody. We definitely hit the goal. Thank you, Underdog, for that $100 super chat. I know there was like a 50 in there from Matt Van Meter. Thank you for that. And thank you guys, everybody. Thank you for all the donations. Super chats, gifted memberships, all that crap. Make sure you go to WATP Live. Again, we're almost a week out from WATP Live in Largo, Florida. Come hang out with us. Cardiff is not going to a baseball game, so don't even try to go to a baseball game. You might as well just go home after the show. He doesn't want to hang out with you. They're all sold out. They're all sold out. And if they're not, Cardiff is very afraid that the giant crowd from WATP, all the people that are flying in for this show, are going to take up all the spring seat. Wait, do they have like real? Oh, yes. Let's get ballpark food. Oh, now I'm excited for ballpark food.
That's all I'm thinking about. Cracker Jack, sir.
Yes. And overpriced hot dogs. Oh, it's going to be fantastic. But yeah, come hang out with us. WATPlive.com. And of course, hackamania.com. Come hang out with us then. And yeah, I don't know. OJ, what are you doing?
Sunday morning. I've been going out at 7 a.m. It's either going to be 7 or 8 o'clock in the morning on my at Obnoxious John on YouTube.
Mm-hmm. Sunday mornings with Obnoxious John. What is that? What is this? car-rep.com/. Oh, okay. So this is, how do you say his name? Lauchy?
Lauchy McDonald, sir.
Lauchy McDonald.
Or Lockie McDonald.
Or Lockie, sir. Lockie McDonald is in some kind of contest. He's the guy who made Cardiff's mask.
And the creep off wheel, sir.
And he made the creep off wheel. Very talented individual. He has actually designed, what is that, a spray?
It's a contest to design spray. It's just an artistic contest, sir.
Oh, fantastic. Yes. So, yeah, go to Cardiff Electric's Twitter, I think is the best way. And Cardiff has tweeted it. And go vote for our friend. This is his design. Yes. And it'll say his name in the description. Again, Lauchy Metcalf or something. What was
McDonald's,
it?
Sir.
Oh, McDonald. MacDonald.
I keep calling him McDonald's.
Yes. Oh, I'm starving. Am I really getting 20 inches of snow? I did not hear that much. I have to look into that now. But yeah, some of those are pretty cool.
Not as cool as...
Yes. Not as cool as that one.
This is the coolest one.
Yes. Is it, though?
Yes, it is.
Yes, yes, it is. Yes, it is.
It's the coolest.
This is the coolest. What does he win?
A trip to Finland, sir.
What?
And he said he's going to take Cardiff.
No. No. Oh, we have to have him win now. That's fantastic. So, yeah, go there. But the easiest way is to go to Cardiff Electric's Twitter. Mm-hmm. I know he posted about it recently. And, I did too, at BeDabbler on Twitter. So you can do that. Cardiff, what else do you want to plug? Or Ralph, whatever your stupid name is.
WATPlive.com, sir.
Fix Tookie. WATPlive.com, yes, at CardiffElectric.com, Patreon.com/CardiffElectric, and Patreon.com/BeDabblerNetwork. I did okay. So, Ralph, OJ, if you guys want to leave, you can leave. But I did promise we would end the show with a 4-minute hype train.
Okay, not Galaga.
Okay, Galaga. Tookie. It's not a Tookie hype train. But a Chad Zumok hype train. This is Chad Zumok's hype train from today. count the super chats. Tookie loves you all more than a friend.
Just don't forget John's mom's box.
Yes, I was just about to say, you cunt.
Don't forget, sir.
I was just about to talk about that old lady's cunt. So we're going to do it right now. Tookie loves you all more than a friend. We'll see you Saturday morning, most likely. No promises, but most likely we'll see you Saturday morning. And remember, John's mom's box.
Fuck it. I'm going to do a midway hype train. I don't give a fuck. I need a hype train to cleanse. You guys cool with that? Let's go hype train cleanse. Hype train. I've never done a hype train this early before. Hype train. I just sprung it on you too. Yes, let's hype. Hype trains. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, I'd like to bring onto the hype train a gentleman who's a friend of mine that I'll be working with for the next 2 weeks. All shows sold out. Naples, eight shows at Off the Hook Comedy Club. Danny Yaw Beach. Did I say it right? Six shows next week. You know him from shows like Reno 911, the cult classic Grandma's Boy, Adam Sandler films, his comedy specials, the very funny Nick Swartzen. Welcome to the hype train, Nicky. Little Nicky. Why can't I find it? Here we go. Welcome, Nick. Let's hype train.
Are you ready? Dance.
Hype train, Nick. Yeah, that's how you hype train. Hype train, Nick. Yeah. Celebrity hype train, everybody. Hype train. Hype train, Nick. Nick, you killed the hype train, baby. Woo! Wow, Kevin. Spencer K's on the hype train. He's been a member for 10 months. Woo! Thank you, Spencer. Colt C's been on the hype train. Oh, see, hype train, hype, hype train, hype train. Ken Mosca's on the hype train. Hype train.
I use your hype train.
Yeah, I know, baby. Hype train, American boy. We are doing it. We are doing it. Woo! Jeff Closer's on the hype train. No, there is no handicap accessibility on the hype train. You will roll the fuck off the hype train. Is this getting longer? It seems like the more I do it, it gets longer. Here we go. Jesus Christ. That thing never ends. That thing never ends.
Get your dumb ass up, cause it's time for Tookie Soup. The taste is gonna move ya with OJ and Ralph. The taste will make you lose it when you pop it in your mouth. Tookie Soup is gonna move ya. Save a show, but it'll do ya. Tookie Soup.
Sit, Eugene, sit. Good dog.
That's the end of my show, Donk.